Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to this emergency broadcast. As you can see, I'm wearing my emergency red to let people know that there's an emergency happening. I'm here with Poseidon. We got a lot of stuff to announce.
Yo.
It's crazy out there. People are losing their goddamn minds.
Yeah.
We're going to talk about it in a second. And yeah, I don't care about copyright strikes. We're going to listen to Bob Marley so you guys can calm the fuck down a bit. Calm your el tites.
Yeah.
Poseidon, let me show them what you're up to today.
How you doing, guys?
How you feeling? Still anxious?
Yeah, still a little worried.
Don't worry, Poseidon. No. It's gonna be fine.
I'm worried more about my mom and my brothers.
Yeah, yeah. I just want to let you guys know that a couple things. Number one, I just canceled the Sherbrooke show because the venue has to close for about a month or something, but it goes past the event date, and I just refunded everyone. I was doing that while we were setting up the podcast. And Eventbrite, fucking sneaky cocksuckers, because they asked me, do I want to pay the service fees so that people get fully refunded? I said yes, so then they charged me. Instead of just refunding everything, since nothing's happening, the coronavirus, decided to make money off me to refund tickets. So we did that shit. But it's all right. I'll probably be back in Sherbrooke once this whole shit dies down. Poseidon knows that this is the only live that I wasn't sure about doing because I was just looking at what's going on. But then I figured people need it. People are home and they need something to watch. So we said, fuck it, let's talk about it. Plus, I want to update you guys on a lot of stuff. A lot of stuff is happening, Poseidon. Stuff that we talked about on the way here. So guys, for those of you who don't know, here in Quebec, it's basically a quarantine zone because they just announced today that bars, theaters, gyms, pools, ski hills for all you fucking white people are asked to be closed. Closing down. No pooling, no skiing, no gymming, no theater, no bars.
Yeah.
Also restaurants to run at 50% capacity to give people space. Now, for people that work in bars and theaters, all that, man, you guys got to remember, they have to pay the bills.
Yep.
And now a lot of people are going to be out of work. So this ain't good. This ain't good for a lot of people. This is going to fuck over a lot of workers. That's what sucks because rent is still due. Mm. People still need to buy shit to survive. And this is coming at a really, really fucked up time. And hopefully the government at least will be fast with a lot of restaurant workers and seasonal workers that are allowed to take their unemployment, you know, when you're off work. Hopefully they can work quickly to get that out there. But you never know.
But still, usually it takes like two to 3 weeks to file the, like, for the unemployment thing to go everything and through and
yeah. But this is the kind of stuff where they should put it.
Top priority.
Yeah, they should fucking fast track this.
I'm just wondering how they're gonna handle it with an influx of people. Let's say.
Yeah, yeah, that's we're about to find out if our system can sustain that. And they are giving out conflicting information. I'll say that much about what's happening now. That's pissing me off. They were telling you the second you feel any types of symptoms, you got to go get checked out, which is what the fuck I did, right? Like a fucking idiot, fucking spending $1,000 to go get everything fucking checked out at the private clinic last minute. And I knew when I walked in and the guy looked at me, he's like, yeah, you don't have coronavirus, bro. I was like, what are you talking about? I had fever yesterday. He's like, yeah, but you're over your fever. Like, yeah, but my throat. I was like, yeah, it's not a dry cough. You have snots. Like, you're just sick. And I was like, all right, if it's that fucking simple, still give me all the blood tests. So I did all the blood tests. We're going to find out tomorrow if I have diabetes. But evidently not that. But then now they're telling people, don't even go get checked if you have symptoms. The only time you should stay home and isolate yourself. The only time that you should go get checked is if you can't breathe or you're like, your shit's serious. So which is it? Like, what do you want people to fucking do? You know, just decide. I don't want people to panic, but just decide what you want people to do in this situation. Now, I'm really serious. Don't fucking panic because it's not going to help. Because most of us, we're going to be fine anyway. Even if you get the coronavirus, here's what's going to happen. Most people are going to get this virus anyway by the end of the year. Within a year, most of us are going to have gotten it. What they're trying to do now is just isolate it so that not everybody gets it at the same time, so everything doesn't shut down. And in doing that, everything's shutting down. So, a little strange.
Yeah.
But what are they going to do? They're trying their best. At least here in Quebec, they're taking it seriously.
Yeah.
And they're trying their best to stop from happening. It's just what's going to happen to, like I said, people that can't work from home. Schools are closed, so some people have to stay home, take care of their kids. A lot of people, like I said, restaurants, bars mostly, that have to close, and theaters. These guys, man, they're out of a job.
Yeah. I know.
So, and everybody lives, the whole North American game is the whole majority of people paycheck to paycheck.
Yeah.
You just fuck people over. So just think about that when, you know, and I guess Uber Eats is going to work though. You can Uber Eats that shit.
Uber Eats might make a ton of money.
That's who's making money now. The elites are the Uber Eats.
And it's very simple, eh? Without getting into contact, you just drop the food at the door and just dip.
It's going to be a bunch of old Indian men with face masks dropping your food off. They're the ones making the money.
Yo, new hustle game 2020.
Shane Gills was right. We don't want to listen. So, Maga Mail said the same thing. So, welcome to everybody in the chat. I see you guys are all at home. We got Jess here. Who do we have? We have Ray Miller, Viron's in the chat, Trey Cool, C8455, Psycho Hazard, Giggity Giggity. Elijah is here. Fuck, Marie Renee is here. Everyone's here. Okay. So, there's a lot of people that said hi in the beginning. We're not going to get to everyone. We don't want to slow this down. Pierre Michelle is here. So welcome, guys. I know it's fucking crazy. So we had to cancel all our show. I'm telling you, Mike didn't want to cancel this whole month. A lot of us didn't want to do this.
Mm.
It's more of we honestly, it's because I see assholes now that are still doing shows around. And I actually had a show yesterday that I thought wasn't going to get canceled. I had to kind of negotiate to push to get it canceled. At some point, you have to like kind of fuck off and cancel your shit because as much as you want to do this, isn't a free speech thing. The government's not stopping me from having freedom of speech. It's just to not fuck someone over.
Yeah.
Because if I decide I want to be an asshole and I need your validation that much that fucking you have to come out to my show and then you get sick because fucking Poseidon has AIDS or some shit. And then, you know, I don't want to be responsible for that.
Yeah. Yeah, nah, I know. But.
Yeah. So, no. It's a time to do that. You know, just settle down a bit. You don't have to go super crazy like Poseidon, but settle down a bit. Luckily, you guys have podcasts. For the record, this week, me and Mike already recorded our podcast yesterday.
Mm.
The reason we did it had nothing to do with coronavirus. It just had to do with luck. We have our guest, Akash Singh from Flagrant 2. He was in, so we recorded a very, very fucking fun podcast yesterday. You guys are going to love it this week. It was a great show. Plus, it gives me and Mike the chance to take off this week so that we don't have to burden anyone to show up to the bordel. Pierre could stay home. You know, we don't want anybody going out if they don't have to at this point for a lot of reasons, not just in case you come into contact with someone, but also since people are fucking stupid already. They don't know how to drive here. Imagine in a panic.
Oh, forget it.
Someone's driving to the hospital because he thinks he has fucking coronavirus. You know, really, it's just that fucking Cheeto that's stuck in his neck and his throat. And you don't want
to. Yeah, it would be pandemonium.
Yeah, it would be fucking crazy. And we're not really pushing any tickets or anything right now, just because tickets, first of all, won't move right now because people are scared to buy shit. And also, it's not the time. We got podcasts now. This is our time to shine. As podcasters, this is our time to shine. Like, I'll tell you guys right now, since all of my month got canceled, basically, in terms of stand-up, I got a lot of time and I got a lot of footage from Poseidon. I have Quebec City. I got footage from him there. So views of Simpleton, I could edit that. This is the best time to be on my Patreon right now because I'm fucking I'm putting up everything this month. And he's going live next week.
Yeah,
I'm going to his house with a suit, obviously. Next week he's gonna have a green screen, lights. It's gonna be a whole new setup. So you're gonna see Poseidon's live stream next week. It's gonna be a whole different thing.
It's gonna level up,
bro. Yeah, he's gonna go in the hospital. So you're gonna see him with his green screen. He'll be wherever the fuck he wants to be. Goddamn mutant.
Oh, shit.
Who would have thought at the end of the world, this is it. These are the broadcasters you're going to listen to.
Well, even Hollywood, what did I hear? 6 months?
3 to 6 months.
3 to 6 months.
Hollywood is shutting down most of its major productions. You know what that means. We're Hollywood now, boys and girls.
Yeah.
This is the film you're watching.
Yeah, I always wanted to make it to Hollywood one way or another.
Yeah.
This is me projecting. Coronavirus is my fault.
Yeah, because most of the shit's down. I mean, even I was supposed to do a radio appearance tomorrow. I got a message. I knew it was going to happen, but I got a message that was canceled as well because they're scared of coronavirus. So, yeah, mainstream media, checkmate. Also, they're not letting 70-year-old people out. They said 70-year-old people stay home, which is also good. A lot of these old fuckers are not on the roads, right? Yeah. Makes it safe for you to drive a bit.
Yeah. And a lot less traffic.
Yeah, people are scared.
Like, almost no traffic. Look at that. They're flying by on the highway. It's crazy.
But I'm not making fun of anyone for panicking, because like I said, I panicked.
I panicked too.
The only person that I think wasn't panicked was the employees at the clinic when they were looking at me. They all had jokes about me. None of them had panic. The best was, you know, you're wearing that mask upside down. And then I didn't want to change it. They're like, why aren't you turning around? I go, I've committed. This is the look now. I've committed to this look.
You know, it's either the end of the world or after this, a lot of comics are going to have a lot of good jokes after this.
Dude, I'm going to talk about that experience. I'm gonna have to make it into a joke on stage because it was just, it was pretty funny.
Oh, man. This is going to be interesting, the way things play out.
Yeah, let's see how it happens. Akash Singh texted me this morning. He was on the way back. He was on the plane.
Okay, good.
So I didn't hear anything. I think he made it to New York safe.
Okay.
Told him we'll be down there in May. By the way, he wanted to thank everyone. He wanted to thank you, everyone at the Bordello. Everyone was cool with him. Yeah. He appreciated you taking care of him and the homies yesterday.
Yeah.
So, and if you guys get a chance, Flagrant 2, Andrew Schultz and Akash Singh. Fucking Alex Media's on that too. Great, great fucking podcast.
Super funny, yeah.
Super, super good podcast. And great fucking guest. I can't wait till you guys see the episode. This week is real funny. Two Drink Minimum. Check it out. So Guido's in the chat. Guido, another panicky bitch. Guido texted me this fucking morning panicking. What did your results say? Like, like, bro, if I have diabetes, it's not going to affect you. The guy already told me when I walked in I don't have fucking SARS. Which is SARS, I guess. Coronavirus. That's all that fucking matters. SARS. Yeah. Even Phil was panicking. Because we were all sick kind of this week, right?
Yeah.
So but this is the year. This is the time of the year where everybody gets sick anyway. But everyone was fucking shitting it. Everyone thought, myself included. Oh, fuck, I got that corona. Yeah. Got that corona, bro.
Me, around this time of the year, I get a little congested because of the weather change and it's springtime, allergies. Yeah. But like you said, if you have mucus, you're good.
Here's another thing that fucked with me. So that's what he told me. He goes, it's not a dry cough. You have, cough. You have, you know, whatever. You have, it's not, it's wet.
Yeah.
But then I read yesterday online, they said that that's not fucking true.
Oh, for fuck's sake,
they said,
bro,
it could be any cough.
God damn it.
Yes, I'm like, who the fuck is making these rules up?
Oh, man. I think they're doing this on purpose.
I'm not doing it on purpose, I think. But the guy was, look, honestly, if the doctor thought I had anything, he wouldn't have let me take off my mask and then put his face right in my mouth. He wouldn't have done that.
Like, yeah, there's that also.
And then we talked about comedy a bit.
Yeah.
So,
Fuck, man.
I think we're good.
Shit's wild out there, bro.
Yeah, look, the point is, guys, just watch out for old people mostly. Young people too, but mostly for old people. That's it. That's all. It's for old, because most of us are probably going to end up getting it, they said, by the end of the year. You're going to recover. It's just going to be a hard flu. They're just trying to protect the old right now, which is good. Somebody needs to protect these guys.
No.
Also, let me say something. Unpopular opinion. China needs to fucking pay. At some point, China's going to have to pay fucking damages for all this shit. Nobody wants to say, because apparently when you want to blame a government, you're racist. So, because I'm saying the People's Republic of China, the communist regime over there, the fact that we are finding out now that they knew since November and they were trying to fucking hide this shit when they could have cut off the supply of this goddamn virus. They could have fucking cut that city off, right, and locked it down and stopped this from fucking happening, okay? They didn't. They were hiding it. Anyone that was talking shit about it, they were mysteriously disappearing. And then right now, this tycoon in Beijing who was talking a lot of shit, he disappeared. New York Times just released an article. So what the fuck? At what point, like once, twice, at what point are we like, listen, guys, you just affected the world economy, not by accident. You actively tried to hide this. It wasn't a slip up. Mm. You actively fucked around. At what point are they held responsible? Right?
Yeah, I know. I know what you mean.
And then I go look online, and anytime somebody says what I just said, they're like, yeah, it's not a time to be racist toward the Chinese people.
People.
Nobody said be racist. I didn't tell you stay away from Chinese people. What I'm saying is the Chinese government has to take responsibility for trying to hide this shit.
People who say that? Yeah. You don't know. You don't understand. My blood boils every time I hear someone say that. My blood is like, you fucking idiot.
Buffoons. A lot of buffoonery out there. They literally, the world economy ate a dick. And now people, like I said, people in the service industry, and that's just here. What about other places? Like the whole, they're not going to have any money.
Zero.
Imagine a month. Imagine if you're living paycheck to paycheck and you're like, oh, fuck, I had to decide whether I'm going to pay my rent or fucking get some food. Now I can't decide because I have no money. Like, people are going to get really, really fucked. So while the governments are saying, okay, we're going to help out as much as we can, it's not even up to your government. It's not their fault.
Mm.
But the people whose fucking fault it is,
the Chinese,
they're staying
government.
Quiet. Yeah. Fuck that, man. Hold them accountable. That's what I say.
And I remember seeing a video a few weeks ago. It was a Chinese minister or something. He came out and he was blaming Trump you remember that?
Did
you
see it? Somebody wants to blame Trump.
He tried to blame Trump for putting for fear mongering.
Yeah, in the beginning. Like that. Yeah. I'm like, what? But look, guys, like, okay, this is not the time. He's the wrong person to blame. He's going to do this.
Yeah. Oh, I saw a video that was fucking hilarious. I saw it was a black gay dude, and he makes videos online. And he goes, I just want y'all to know, we all gonna die. I go, okay, where's he going with this? And he goes, Donald Trump is reading off a teleprompter. Y'all, we gonna die.
Yeah, because he was nervous. You saw Trump.
Yeah, I saw him. Yeah.
Dude, because what do you do? What do you do? Yeah. And, you know, all this shit tied in. I saw something earlier, and I want to verify, like, all the details so I could be. So a lot of people in Italy are still dying. Now, the reason is because a lot of these old people that are getting sick, Italy doesn't have, like, Northern Italy in the lockdown doesn't have a lot of respirators because that's what you need to help you breathe.
Yeah.
So they're kind of picking who lives and who dies, right?
That sucks, man.
Here's what's fucked up. I found out that in the last decade, healthcare in Italy, the government kept cutting it, right? Because they had to allocate funds to take care of refugees. And it's in the tune of either it was 10 billion or 10 trillion that they allocated to. So everything is tied in. It's a well-balanced ecosystem, right? So the one place where you should never have to cut money from or actively try to is healthcare for reasons like this.
Because
you never know what's going to happen. So it's fucking... I saw that. I was like, ooh, that's rough to know that you cut spending. Like you cut funding healthcare. That's fucking scary. Yeah.
That's Akfade.
It's Akfade. Yeah, it's fucking crazy.
Bro, you know it's Akfade. You know it's fucked when the Pig Latin comes out by itself on a podcast. Bro.
Yeah. It's absolutely ridiculous, all right? So you guys are going to be spending a lot of time inside for the next little while. Mm. I like that Guido wrote, Italy corruption, bro, you surprised. What I just described isn't corruption, though, Guido. What I just described is that, other reasons came into effect. Like, for example, the whole refugee crisis in Italy, right? That Italy was trying to... That was Europe deciding you have to take care of these refugees because the North doesn't want them.
Yeah.
But we're also not going to help you financially figure it out. So then that's how they have to figure it out, right? They have to remove from other... But you don't have money.
Yeah.
Right? You got to shift everything.
And this is
crazy.
This is also going to raise tensions amongst people also because now also people are going to point fingers. Oh, it's your fault. We couldn't handle this. They're going to blame refugees.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
This is going to become a shit show.
In times of crisis, people take beatings.
That's
for goddamn sure.
Oh, yeah. So, yeah, it's going to get fucked up out there, bro, if you think about it, if everything ties in like that.
Well, here in Montreal, I don't think anyone's like, we're not really angry.
No, but there's tension. People are tense. You could tell.
Like, the only anger I have is towards the communist regime of China for fucking everyone over.
Yeah.
But not for, I'm not even mad at, like, tourists that come back and are sick. I don't care that. It's not your fault that you got infected. What is fucked up, though? I saw something. I saw a woman. I tweeted it. She was coming back. She's from Toronto, Canadian. She was coming back from Mexico with her husband. And she was freaking the fuck out. She goes, what the fuck kind of system do we have here to test people for corona?
I saw that too.
Yeah, she goes, all they did was they asked me, did you go to Iran, Korea, or China? Or Italy, sorry. And she's like, nope. I'm like, all right, go in. But they didn't ask me if I have symptoms, if my husband has symptoms, if we were around people that had symptoms.
Yeah.
None of that. She goes, what the fuck is this? So she goes, as a precaution, we're going to isolate ourselves for 2 weeks just in case. But what the fuck? She goes.
Yeah. And it makes watching that made me incredibly fucking nervous.
Yeah, dude. Because the federal government has to fucking shape up.
Yeah, bro. Because I work at an airport too, eh? Don't forget.
Yeah, I know.
So that, watching that made me incredibly nervous. I was like, motherfuckers.
Yeah, it's funny because Trudeau released a photo. There's a photo of him in his home, in his office. Like, they're taking a picture of him in another room. He's like, working from home. Stupid. Take care of the goddamn airports, you dipshit. We don't need... It's not Instagram. Like, fuck off, dude. You're the prime minister. Do your fucking job. Right? Issue something. Do those fucking head thermometers from a distance like they do in China. Your temperature's high. Let's check you. That's it.
It's very aggravating.
Yeah. Anyways, you guys are... Don't panic, because even if you get it, you're going to be fine. You're going to go through a shitty flu for a bit. But if you do have respiratory problems, or maybe diabetes, or what else did they say?
Cardiovascular condition.
Any heart problems.
Heart conditions.
Then just, they'll have to... They can assist you. So what they'll do is probably put you on a respirator, and if you... If you kind of do it properly, like you go pretty early on, you'll still more than likely be fine.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's why I'm nervous for my mother. She has asthma.
Yeah.
So if you have asthma, also.
I'm nervous for her because she's your mother.
She's a tough lady, though.
That stress is enough to kill her already.
I see what you did there.
Already. Because she's like, you're mad about the coronavirus. This is my kid. Oh! So for everybody who showed up late, just want to say, I canceled the Sherbrooke show April 3rd because the venue is closed due to, you know, what the government mandated. And I refunded everybody today. So anybody who bought tickets there, the money is in your accounts. You go check that out.
In your account.
Yeah, in your account.
I don't know why I sung that.
I did it instantly. Somebody messaged me. They go, yo, look, the venue said they're canceling their shows. So I went, pop, refund. And they should have an easier refund policy. I had to refund everyone one by one.
Yeah, it's a little,
that was very time-consuming. Yeah. When Poseidon gets scanned, the thermometer explodes every time.
So he just don't know how to deal with me. Does he have it? Does he not?
Just scans. Normally, it's temperatures. Him, it just says retarded.
That was funny.
Let's see. Your shows in April are pretty much canceled, too. TV, film production, North America are done. Yeah, a lot of, goddamn, it's crazy. I'm kind of lucky to be able to do what I do, you know, the podcasting, the writing, you know, all that shit. Like, goddamn, it's going to, comes in useful right now.
Oh, yeah.
Imagine if you had to go 9 to 5 and they shut your shit down. Because I think a lot of offices are going to be closed too, right?
But a lot of office jobs, though, like you're insured.
You can work from home.
You're insured also. So even if you take like sick leave, you could take sick leave like a lot of jobs for up to a year.
I don't think you can take sick leave for a year if you're not sick.
No, I mean if you're sick.
That's not what we're talking about. We're talking about everything's closing down. So if your employer says we can't have you come in if you're at risk or if someone else is at risk, all that shit, right? Work from home, or if you can't work from home, what do you do? Like let's say you have your kids, they're in school, school's canceled. You have to take care of them at home. So you can't go to work and you can't work from home. What do?
You're pretty much fucked.
You're fucked. A lot of people are going to get fucked.
Fuck, bro.
Yeah. Now, you know who's going to really eat a lot of shit? The people who know people that take advantage of the system. Like the people who were taking welfare unemployment but that didn't need it. They were just fucking around.
So, yeah, yeah.
Oh, that's where the hate's going to go.
Oh, yes. With reason. I don't blame people.
Because now that the government actually needs the money,
yeah,
that regular people would use it, yeah, they're going to go find fucking Michelle drinking Mountain Dew in the corner being like, what, bro?
Yeah, with his cap sideways.
Yeah.
Shit's going to get a little crazy.
It's going to be crazy, boys. Boys and girls, let's see. Richard, FYI, NFL just voted to going to a 17-game season. The NFL's fucking talking. The NFL needs to shut the fuck up. Stay quiet right now. Right now it's time for fucking the NHL and the NBA to talk while their seasons got suspended.
Yeah. I saw a video with Stephen Curry. He's about to cough. I don't know if you saw it. He's about to cough. He goes, yeah. And he went to
you know? Anytime you say cough, I feel like coughing. That's another part of the problem.
Yeah.
Is the psychological aspect of it.
Yes.
You start thinking that you're fucking sick, and it feels like the way we're treating it is like a zombie apocalypse.
Who did I hear say this? Some people were saying it's gonna be between like I lost my train of thought.
Yo, look out! If you guys have friends or family, anything, you know, the older people over 60, look out for them. Just give them calls. Make sure they're okay. They don't have any type of you know, worries, whether they're coughing, whether, you know, the mucus. Just make sure you keep an eye, because a lot of people, especially older people, are very proud. They won't tell you if they're feeling under the weather. You know, make sure you bring them shit if you can. And also help out your fucking friends if they're, like I said, in the service industry, and they're losing their jobs for a month. If you can, obviously, help out in any way you can, because a lot of people, man, already we knew that in North America we had that problem with the, you know, the debts are too high. And, you know, the debt at home, everyone's credit card debts, and the paycheck to paycheck. So now without work, a lot of people are going to feel it. So if you can help out your friends, if you know people, Keep that. That's the best thing you could do during this time is take care of the people around you. That's the smartest thing you could do. Not going around and you know, panicking and buying up all the toilet paper. And also, you don't need that much fucking toilet paper. Another thing, like, leave some for the next fucking person.
Yeah.
You goddamn buffoons. Worst case scenario, stock up on water or something instead, because you fucking you could still wash your ass. You know what I mean? But what if you have very clean buttocks because of your toilet paper, but you have no food?
You're fucked. You gotta eat toilet paper.
What are you gonna eat? Shit. Come on.
Shitty toilet paper. Oh, shit. Like, oh, like fucking, you start a fire and you roast it like marshmallows. Ah. Oh.
So Gabe says that the prime minister said that the employment insurance, if you go online, it won't take 3 weeks.
How long is it going
to
take?
They're going to try to get it out. Like, they're going to try to speed everything up fast. Because there's a reason now. You, like, people are completely fucked. Like, they're isolated. You have to help unburden the system, like, right? Unclog the system.
Yeah.
You know, that's also why they're doing this, is to help unclog the healthcare system. Because there's not enough beds. Dude, if everyone starts going in, because they're sick. That's why they can't have everybody get sick at the same time. Because then nothing. Imagine you go to the hospital because you're sick. Everyone's sick. The doctor's fucking sick. Nobody. That's why they're trying. They go, look, everyone's going to get this. 70% of the population or whatever. So let's try and, you know, slow it down.
Imagine people don't have money to buy food, but they're hungry and they need to eat.
Yeah.
Then it's going to get even more fucked up.
Well, what are you talking about? Why that? Even now, if you're hungry and you have no food, that's fucked up. But no, it's not, we're on the third world here.
No, I know.
There's going to be a wave. That's what I'm saying. Also, look out for your fucking friends.
Yeah.
Yeah. Ow.
There was there was something that I read that I found very funny. There was a
The fact that you can read, hilarious.
There was a guy that bought a shit ton of Purell, but because he overcharged on Amazon something, they banned them.
Yeah, they banned a lot of people.
And now he's stuck.
Fuck that guy.
He's stuck with, I think, what was it? 3,000 liters worth of Purell.
He's a fucking vulture.
And
fuck,
doesn't know what to do with it. He's pissed.
Oh, I know what he does. How about he fucking drinks it, that piece of shit?
Yeah.
Yo, I found out yesterday when I was at the bordel with Mike, because Danielle at the bordel, she makes her own Purell. And when Mike told me, I thought that was a joke. And then apparently, guys, look online. You could make your own Purell. And it's not that hard.
How?
You can make. I think you need...
Vodka?
You need like 70% alcohol or more, I think. Uh-huh. And... I think bleach or some shit. Point is, you can make it. Like, she made it. You can make it.
Huh.
Yeah. Especially industrious people. Like, if people like cooking and all that stuff, they can make it.
Interesting.
Yeah. Jean-René Dufour has a video, Marie-René says. So there you go. Yeah. You can make it. So just don't stress, is what I'm saying. Don't fucking...
Yeah.
Don't let this get you. The only thing you need to worry about is make sure, like, around for the next month, you know what the fuck... is going around, like, you know what you're going to do, how you're going to get food or whatever, and that the people that are the most at risk around you, you're taking care of them. And at risk for everything, at risk for the cough, for getting sick, and at risk, you know, if they have no money, or they can't shop, help them out, because, you know, a lot of people are going to be out of a job this month. That's it. The rest, don't worry about it. Don't stress. Everything's going to fall into place. And then if you do get the coronavirus and you're young, 2 weeks, once you're out of it and you're good, fuck it, go buy some discount tickets.
Travel the world.
Go somewhere you've never been. Go somewhere you've never been.
I actually hope I catch it right now, actually, now that you say that. Because in 2 weeks from now, I have my week vacation coming up.
There you go. Poseidon, the only person on the cruise.
The only person on a cruise ship, bro.
It's just this fucking buffoon.
And I'm immune because I already caught it.
Yeah.
I'm there. I'm fucking farting, shooting fireworks by myself.
Sure, you realize there's an epidemic. Bro, don't worry about it. You can't get corona twice, can't get AIDS twice. Me, I'm good.
The only corona I'm infected now is the beer, bro.
Even I'm pretty sure that your prostitutes, if you would reach out to them, they'll tell you that even their game affected for sure. Who's
for
going
sure,
prostitutes right now?
Nobody. But some of these fucking whores, I've noticed.
All right.
I've noticed because I got curious, right? And I went on one of those websites. Okay.
I got curious. What do you mean? I mean, it was a Saturday.
You like the way I said that, though? Yeah. Your reaction was priceless. So I got curious. The hot ones, what I've noticed is they've dropped their prices.
Very smart. Good at business.
Dropped their prices. And they wrote shit like, don't let the coronavirus steal your joy, whatever. Come relax. No, no, no.
How are you? How do you relax?
By her sucking your dick. First. Second, I noticed the ugly ones. The ugly ones. The ones that are overweight, but not good overweight, like bad overweight.
Okay.
And that are ugly.
So fucking Lizzo's out here charging double.
Basic. Yes. Yes.
Which you know why? They don't have the savings because they didn't make as much this year. And like, yo, shit, I got to eat. But they're panicking and now they're overcharging. So they're so now they're not gonna get nothing.
That makes sense.
Yeah. Yeah.
That makes sense.
I know people that are dumb at business, sir. I'm around them a lot. Hello.
I was waiting for it.
I know.
And yeah, so that's what I've noticed from the whore world.
Yeah, yes, he says Poseidon's dad just invented Purell with lighter fluid. Because Poseidon's dad, famous inventor, for the dumbest inventions ever. Listen, you douse yourself in gasoline, you light yourself on fire. No germs. But what if you die? It's a risk I'm willing to take.
But fire, and his argument is going to be, but fire does kill germs.
Yeah, it kills a lot of things, you stupid fucker. In 3 weeks, we'll all be a bit late, but better than nothing. Yeah, I think in 3 weeks everything's gonna be fucking. I don't. Here's the thing. Fine. I don't know. Because it's still evolving. A lot of people are saying this is just the beginning.
Yeah.
And Samuel makes a good point. Some people did get the virus twice. Now the only variable in that, because I was watching a report about some guy they put in quarantine, is that they put him in quarantine when he was getting better.
Yeah.
And they go, nice, just leave him in quarantine, and then he got it again. But what they're saying sucks. Is maybe he hadn't fully recovered.
Yeah,
and that's why it hit him hard. So maybe if you let the person fully recover and they develop the antibodies, they won't get it. But I don't fucking know.
I don't know.
It's crazy. I saw a Japanese woman got it twice too.
Yeah. And another thing that stresses me out about this is that apparently this virus can evolve.
Yeah.
Like become more lethal.
It might turn into a monkey. So
how lethal are monkeys? Wait.
Richard Kish says, Pentels, when in May are you coming? Look, me, Mike, Aaron Berg, Gino Bisconte, our show is supposed to be May. Well, it is. It's May 1st. Two shows, 7 and 9, I think, or 8 and 10 or some shit. As of right now, the show's still a go in May. We have not heard otherwise. Mm. Let's see what happens. I hope it's still a go because everything that we booked is... we booked some cool shows, too, to jump on a couple of cool podcasts while we're there. So it should be fun.
I hope it doesn't get canceled.
But here's the thing that we got to remember. New York, way bigger than Montreal. All my friends in New York that I'm talking to aren't really taking it. Like, they're saying that the people aren't taking it too seriously. Like, people are still fucking around in New York. They don't care. Fuck. New York is so big, though, and people are so fucking close together that if that shit pops off in New York,
it's heavy.
Explodes.
It's heavy. Yeah.
Yeah.
It's super heavy.
So that's the... You know what would have been cool here is if we knew like what neighborhoods it was in, and then we just isolate those neighborhoods.
Well, I'm staying the fuck away from Côte de Neige.
Yeah, Côte de Neige, because we saw the video of a guy.
Yeah. So I'm staying the fuck away from there. Like,
we could all push it just to Laval, and then blow up the bridges.
I was waiting for it.
Have fun, guys. Don't worry, it can't get you at Tim Hortons parking lot.
Because they're distanced so far from each other.
That's why they all hang out in the parking lot.
They knew
from years ago, the Lavalers. That's why they hang out in the parking lots. They don't go inside. They're like, no, no corona for me, sir.
It's funny.
Yeah, the orgy has been canceled, sir.
Oh, shit. That's another thing. What's going to happen with porn?
I got one question here. Can I ask if Suzekut will be actually live? There will be no live Suzekut today, obviously, since the bordel is... we were supposed to be doing Two Drink Minimum live today.
Yeah.
For people who bought tickets, they were refunded. It was fun. It was going to be a good show. Sold out right away.
I was very excited.
And we had Preach was coming in as a guest. So it would have been good. It would have been us and Preach. But we had to cancel that. We also had a stand-up show. Mike was going to do an hour at 7 today. Yeah. So that was canceled. Everything, especially they canceled preemptively just to, actually, maybe there's a live Suzekut. I didn't ask Mike. Maybe they're going to go do through the studio. I'm not sure. Oh, no, no. They're not doing one this Tuesday because they were supposed to do two drink minimum live. Oh, so yeah. Today, I don't think there was a live one scheduled, if I'm not mistaken. I don't know. But they do have a lot in the bank. So Mike does have a lot of episodes, you know, in the tank. So it's not like entertainment's going to stop.
Yeah.
Yeah. So this is the time to... Fuck, this is what's crazy. A lot of people are going to subscribe now to Netflix, Patreon, all that, because they're going to be home a lot just to watch all kinds of shit. So if you ever, you know... If you wanted to get into Game of Thrones, this is the time, I guess.
I'm going to start playing those video games that I hadn't opened up.
Yeah, go ahead.
No.
I'm not.
Why?
I'm going to fucking just make videos and shit.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm going to make videos. I'm going to... I still have my... Like, my writing gigs are still happening. Like, the shows and shit are still happening, so... I'm going to do all that stuff.
Yeah, it's true. It's business as usual.
Besides, there's a live virus out there. You heard that?
Hello?
Go out there and check that out, Poseidon. Go out there and check that out before we get killed.
Where's my machete, bro?
Poseidon's going out there. He's nervous.
Hello?
Yeah, Poseidon's out there checking out the noise. What's the over-under on him getting murdered? Poseidon, maybe something just fell. Wood creaks. Wood creaks, bro. It's okay. Bring it in. Shut the door if you're scared. Don't worry.
I'm not scared. I'm on high alert.
You're on high alert?
High alert.
You know this virus works. They're not zombies, bro.
You never know, bro. Better safe than sorry.
Calm people down. Yeah, you like that?
I just realized we did this to try and calm people down, and I might have inadvertently just fucking spooked everyone.
Yeah, that's why I decided to get the fucking the calming music again, because I was like, Jesus Christ, this guy's gonna scare the shit out of you.
Because I'm very reactive.
Yeah, you're very reactive.
I'm very reactive.
You're
noticed.
You're every R word.
Rigor.
Retarded. Pornhub gave Italy free premiums.
Oh, that's nice.
That's
at least.
I don't know if it's insulting or nice.
Well, apparently masturbation boosts the immune system.
Oh, really?
Yes.
Then we can't defeat you.
I'm the final boss.
You're the final boss. This is the final form of the immune system. It's Poseidon.
It's me.
If you jerk off enough, kids, you could turn into this. Think about that.
Oh, shit.
But Magamil says that masturbation increases white blood cells. Yes.
So it does boost the immune system.
Yeah, only white blood cells though.
What about the black ones? Fucking racist immune
system.
Yeah,
it's just your immune system. It's just hard for them to get work right now. It's crazy. I wonder what cities are gonna implement what. Cause think about countries that are the size of the United States. Like, think about a big country like the States, where there's so many cities, and what do you do if one city is pretty clean, but then neighboring states have huge coronavirus-affected cities? Do you fucking block travel within the country? It's crazy.
Yeah.
You got to think of what you're going to do, yeah.
Man.
India, shit, it's true. Think about India. What the fuck would India do?
Bro. But apparently India didn't get hit that hard.
No, huh?
No.
These Indians.
I wonder why.
I don't know. Well, I guess Chinese people live in India. Because a lot of reason why this spread so far was because of the Lunar New Year, no?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
All
the year of the rat on top of it.
It's the year of the rat, eh?
Yeah.
Fucking vermin. So what happened is during the Lunar New Year for the Chinese, it's one of the times where there's the most like mass migration on the planet because there's so many Chinese people that live all across the world and they go to China, they go home and they come around. So that's apparently what caused it to spread big time. I saw a little documentary on that last week. Yeah. So maybe there's not a lot of Chinese people that live in India, so they didn't really go there. Or maybe a lot of the street Indians, you see the ones that live in those ghettos, maybe they're unkillable now.
Yeah, they've been living in dirt so long, like...
Maybe they have the immune system. Maybe they have the antibodies we need.
Yeah. Because maybe they... Yeah. Yeah. That makes a lot of fucking sense.
Yeah.
Because as for Russell Peters, as soon as you step off the fucking plane in India, it smells like shit. So
you eat enough shit, your coronavirus doesn't touch you.
Yeah.
Is that what you think?
No, but
like, imagine if you were a doctor. What do I do? I'm coughing. Have you thought of eating
your
own feces?
I'm lathering patients and shit. Yeah,
have you thought of eating your own feces? No, I've never thought about that. You should, though. You should consider it. This is like a medical thing. I saw it on YouTube. There's a guy talking about it.
Oh, shit. Oh, man.
Let's see. Yeah, try. They said cancel your vacations. They said cancel your vacations if you can.
Yeah.
Are you nervous right now? You get pissed if people are walking around. Well, maybe somebody else came in to do their shows too, bro. You don't know.
Did someone knock?
No. Did you hear a knock?
I'm paranoid.
No. Who the fuck knows? India doesn't have the resources to test a lot of people. Oh, that's another thing. So they told me, don't just look at the numbers of cases, because that's obviously not true, because that's just people that were tested and we found out. But let's say if there's 50 people that have it, there could be another 60 that have it but just weren't tested.
So what you're saying
is you don't know right now what's going on. You don't really know the real numbers. That's why the government here is trying to shut shit down.
Yeah.
Because you don't know the real numbers. How are you going to... You could guess. And then the metro.
Fuck.
I saw a video of a guy in New York. He was wearing one of the little masks and he looked sick. I guess maybe he was told that he has the coronavirus. It was like last week. And then he licked his hand and started touching the
I saw that video too.
Yeah, you saw that?
That pissed me off.
Yeah, because... That's the kind of motherfucker that you beat to death.
Yeah.
That's the kind of motherfucker
you beat to death. Well, that's going to get beat to death by other people.
Yeah, stay the... If you know you have it, the second you know you have some, try to save people around you. You know, don't pull that. No. That's what Phil told me. Remember Phil, when I got mad at him? Because he goes, if I have it, I'm fucking giving it to everyone. I was like, you don't do that shit. Like, you try to contain it. Yeah, I just remember, and I was yelling at him. I called him a communist. Yeah. You don't do that. You don't get mad at people for because you have the sickness. Oh. You contain it.
Well, communists are all about sharing the wealth, I guess.
No, they're about taking the wealth. Communism is a lie.
Yes.
They're not about building you up. They're about putting people that are above you down because you're too stupid to move up.
Yeah.
That's all it is. And then everybody lives in shit, except for the new elite class that now you can't reach. Whereas if it was a capitalist society, you could still reach the elite class.
Yeah.
Yeah. Anyways, I guess we're in the danger zone, is what they're saying. Marie Renee says, stay home and read a book for once. Yeah, you guys could read books. No one's taking away your fucking internet.
No.
Right? Your internet's there. There are unpublished videos from situations in China. Dude, China is fucked up, man. They're beating people. I saw a lot of videos in China last week. I was looking at a lot of documentaries over the weekend. I saw a video of them welding doors of buildings, of apartment buildings, so people don't come out. They were welding the doors shut. Okay? Now, that's fucked up because I saw people taking a video and they were screaming. Because imagine you're in the building, you're taking a nap, you hear some noise, like, I wonder what's happening out there. And the government is welding your building shut. And then you're fucked. What if you need to eat, to anything? They're going to open a lot of that shit in the next couple of weeks, and there's going to be a lot of dead people.
Yeah. Yeah. 100%.
Yeah, the Chinese don't fuck around, man. It's
especially within the building, if someone gets hungry, they have weapons, yeah. They go into other apartments to take food. Yeah, shit's gonna pop off, bro.
Yeah, and the thing I was thinking about, Poseidon, I was thinking about this. So, I do believe that maybe governments of the first world should start bringing back manufacturing to their own countries, okay? Now, and I remember people's argument was like, no, you can't do that because if you build a phone, let's say you build an iPhone in Canada, it's gonna cost so much more, right? That's not true. I was thinking about this. The only reason why an iPhone will cost that much would be if the company, let's say Apple, is trying to maintain the same profit margin.
Yes, I was about to say that.
Do you get what I'm saying?
Yes, 100%.
So at some point, Apple, maybe you don't need to make as much as a fucking country, okay? Yeah. You keep the fucking price the same or a little bit higher, let's say. You still make money, you just don't make as much as you fucking used to. And then you don't have to depend on this kind of stuff. You know what I'm saying? Sign.
Yeah, I'm just gonna send a text real quick.
It's because I was thinking. I go, wait, that's not true. That's only if you want them to maintain the same profit margins, right?
Yeah.
But the only reason why they're there is because profit margin. Like, oh fuck, why would I pay $2 to make it? I could make it for 10 cents. But maybe it's better that you make it for $2-3.
But how much are they really gonna like?
Giggity just said they all make like 80 to 90% profit points. Yeah, maybe you don't need. Do you know what I mean? Like, look, if I want to Poseidon, let's say this.
But even if they
it cost me $2 to make, let's say this, yeah. And you want this cup, okay? Cost me $2. Yeah, I could sell to you for $5 right now. You know, make $3 off every. Yeah. I could, right? But I could also sell to you for fucking $3 if it really cost me $2 completely to make it, and everything else is profit. Let's say, I could still sell it for less and still make money, and just sell more of it here.
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean? Pantelis, scroll up. Let's see, gapes. Pantelis, China's recovering now, but how can we believe them? They lie so much. Yeah. We're stupid. The face masks are made in China, and they stop shipping them. I have something to say about the face masks. I found this out. I talked about it. So this is fuck, man. This is what's crazy is that when you were talking about, like, they were talking about, you know, trade and having a trade war with China, they were calling Trump racist before, and now they're seeing that, fuck, maybe he was right. Because there's an American company that makes these masks. And they make them, obviously, in China.
Because it's cheap.
So they were getting an order of their face masks that they paid for. They're making. They're manufacturing there in China. And the Chinese government stopped them. And they said, nope, these are staying here because we have a crisis and we need them. Even though they're not technically theirs, it's their company. Yeah. They said, no. This is a communist fucking country. We decide what fucking comes and goes, okay? So it's fucking dangerous when you're not in charge of your medical supplies, when you could make them. When you could fucking make them. These are not third world countries. The United States, Canada, the fucking European countries. You could make this shit at home if you weren't concerned with maximizing every fucking penny. You know, just milking every fucking penny. And then in a case like this, you at least have your own medical supplies being made at home. You know, like during war times where they used to want during World War II, they used to recycle everything and they used to make everything at home to fight the war, let's say. Now if everything's fucking outsourced, it's scary because in times like this, times of crisis, you're fucked.
Yeah, imagine there's a war, you're waiting on a shipment of guns.
Yeah. It's fucking crazy.
Yeah.
You get stunted. It's kind of like right now, people who have gardens in their home looking at everyone else and laughing.
Yes. That's true. Yeah. Fuck, my dad has a garden in his backyard. Yeah. He's probably laughing.
Well, does he have anything in the garden or just flowers?
No, he's growing tomatoes.
There you go. You can make a salad.
Yeah. What was he growing? He was growing tomatoes, cucumbers.
Oh, very good.
Cucumbers are very good. They're like 98% water.
Your dad, one step ahead of the average man.
Yeah.
Yeah.
He was laughing when I told him about this, about what he thinks. He goes, this is just a test.
Yeah, your dad's a dipshit. We already talked about this here.
Oh, boy.
Let's see. Pantel's May 1st is a Friday. If you can, you and Mike should do Gum Fridays. We could. I think we were supposed to fly in on Thursday, so we should be able to do it. But again, let's see, Richard, what the fuck's going to happen, because we don't know how long this is going to go. And
no.
I'm more worried about New York shutting shit down for a longer time because there's so many fucking people, you know? Unless something happens between now and then and they fast track some kind of a vaccine.
Yeah.
But the issue with the vaccine, we were talking about at the restaurant yesterday. At the bar, there's all these laws in place and regulations which are valid, and it only takes months. It could take up to 16 months to get everything tested, get clinical trials, all that. So even if it's the same vaccine that, let's say, they discovered today, it might not be out for another 16 months because of all the shit. So hopefully they're going to try to fast-track some stuff, because I know an Israeli company Israeli scientists isolated the gene just like the Canadian scientists, they figured some stuff out. But they have to move on to animal testing and all that. So, you know, there's a lot that still has to happen. Let's see.
We'll see how the events unfold.
Look, worst case scenario. I mean, we're always gonna try our best to be around to do podcasts, keep people entertained. I said initially, I wasn't gonna do this today, and then I said, fuck it. It's the opposite. It's, you know, probably should do it. People are fucking staying home. Give them something to watch and talk about. Yeah. And look at the chat and look at the amount of people that are watching. Clearly, you're not alone. So there's a lot of people thinking about this shit. There's a lot of people that are just nervous. And I'm telling you, be more nervous about your economic situation than about the actual virus. Because most of us were in that health group where we're going to get past it after a week or two, let's say, whatever it takes. But people that are losing their jobs right now, that's going to be fucking tough.
Well, that's what I'm worried about, is I'm worried about what happens if everything goes into lockdown in the city. Like, imagine the whole city going into fucking lockdown.
Well, look, already now, 70-year-old people are asked to stay home.
Yeah.
Bars, theaters, gyms, pools, ski hills, closed indefinitely until further notice. Restaurants are asked to operate at 50% capacity to give people breathing room. So there's a lot of that shit happening. There was Pantelis Live or Pornhub lesbian category. I chose Pantelis Live. Goddamn right. You chose correctly. Because I'm only here live now, and then after, you get to go to the Pornhub. The economy is going to take a big hit. Yeah.
Yeah.
Now, if you guys have money saved up, this is your moment. Yeah. You will be millionaires in at least a year or two if you invest in stocks that you know are going to bounce back, like shit that's always making money.
Nike, Coca-Cola.
Yeah, shit like that.
Yeah.
This, you see it dip significantly because you know that's not the real number.
Yeah.
Yeah.
What about gas, bro? Gas prices. It's $25 a barrel. It was $77 a barrel.
Yeah.
It has dropped down to $25 a barrel.
Yeah, I'm going to go fill up when I leave here.
More than 50%, bro. Like, it's nuts. But we're still getting fucked at the pumps here. Like, it's nuts.
Samuel says, Poseidon looks like a lesbian. First he said Pantelis, but then he said he misspoke.
Oh.
Well, I don't know if he looks like a lesbian anymore because of that big stash.
Yeah.
If he gets rid of it, yeah. So Marvin
says... That's
why
I didn't get rid of it, actually.
Moved all his retirement savings to bonds in February. Saved me over $30,000. Dude, my buddy Harry, the stock genius... Lost fucking all kinds of money these past couple of weeks. And he's like, because it's unprecedented. Mm. You didn't realize how this virus was going to... Because China was lying.
Yeah.
If China fucking took care of business in November, this would have never happened. You know? And also, there's a fucking guy. Fuck, man. So Tim Pool. You guys know Tim Pool? Tim Pool was talking about this. Tim Pool was mentioning about how some people were like, maybe... The way it started isn't exactly how we think. Because right in front of that Wuhan market, there's that fucking place where they test for toxins and bioengineering shit and all that. It's a, they have a whole lab with scientists right in front.
Yeah.
Because people were saying they thought that it was made in a lab because it was like too perfect or whatever the fuck. So what they said is there's this one guy that the real patient zero might not be the first old man that had the case. Might be a guy right before him who worked, a scientist who worked at the plant. And was a fucking buffoon.
Butterfingers.
Because the way he described him is he goes, this guy apparently in the report a few months ago was already urinated on by one of the bats.
That's a weird.
The urine was on his skin. First of all, why are you not wearing a suit?
That's a strange kink though.
Why are you not wearing a suit, right? And then he goes, the same guy also got bitten by one of the bats there when they were testing shit. And his blood mixed with the bat's blood and all that. Like, dude, who the fuck is this guy? Get him out. Get him out of that fucking facility. You know what I mean?
Man, they hired a freak, bro.
Yeah, they hired
a kinky shit.
You know, like fucking leave the bats alone, stupid. You know, he's fucking. So yeah,
he's having sex with turtles.
Yeah. No, but mistakes were made. So there's a lot of scary shit out there. Bat lives matter. Yes, he says.
I read something recently that made me really laugh. Somebody wrote, he goes, man, I'm higher than a giraffe's pussy to care about what's going on. Just the fact that he said he's higher than a giraffe's pussy made me laugh.
Yeah, it's not. It's more like I said. It's most for old people. Watch out for. Watch out for the elderly, and also you know what? If you're cool and you could drive around, this is the best time. No old people driving. A lot of people are staying at home. This is a good time.
Oh my god! I can't believe I completely forgot about this. You know what happened?
If this disease only affected women and they had to stay home, the streets would never have been safer.
Well, I was about to get... You know what happened yesterday?
I was just fucking around.
Well, hold on. There was a... This is a situation with a woman driver.
Yeah.
As I was leaving, I went to the grocery store, the one behind the McDonald's there, the... What's it called? Metro?
Yeah.
Yeah. And as I turned out, I took a right. And you know there's the far left lane?
Yeah.
This woman started overtaking somebody, because she was panicking, overtaking somebody from the left and came onto the oncoming traffic lane.
Holy shit.
I started honking at her, and then she started honking too and pointed the finger at me. So she knew what she was doing. So I was like, bro, what the fuck? People have like...
You know. But yeah, this happens a lot of fucking idiots that drive. Like, I fucking fall them home and break their legs.
Like, bro, chill, bro.
So Gapes is saying the irony of bioweapons is that countries who have developed them a lot, they also inadvertently destroyed themselves. Japan tried this in World War II with mosquitoes, and it killed their whole lab.
Oh, Jesus Christ.
Yeah.
Wait, with mosquitoes?
Yeah, they're trying to poison people with mosquitoes. Because mosquitoes are carriers too, right? Because
they suck
the blood and put it in.
Oh, shit.
So, yeah, it's kind of like what used to make me nervous, I remember, to like donate blood or anything like that, was back in the day, some people get, even here in Montreal, we know somebody at the cafe who got sick because of a transfusion. You know what I'm talking about? like somebody that has AIDS or something that has a blood disease, they don't sterilize or they give you the properly or they give you the wrong needle, the wrong tube, and then you get infected. That's happened. Yeah, so accidents happen. So you think if accidents happen in simple cases like that, they're not going to happen in complicated cases like bioweapons?
Oh, yeah.
Accidents happen. So you shouldn't play with shit like that.
Yeah, but it's in human nature, I guess, to fuck around.
Yeah, but the planet doesn't fuck. Dude, we're actually lucky that this isn't worse, that it's not like respiratory. Yeah. Because if it was everybody has the same reaction as old people, like you can't breathe, most of us would be dead right now. Yeah. There's no way to save everyone. Like, we'd be fucked.
Yeah. This would be a lot more serious. But wasn't there the whole avian flu that killed 60%?
Well, this is that type of flu too. They're all kind of, they're all related.
Yeah. But that one was even more intense and it had originated in China also. Hmm. But that, because it killed 60% of the cases, they shut down on it real quick.
Yeah.
You know?
But well, the only, it's easier, obviously, if it's highly contagious, but it kills the host quickly. It's easier to contain because you just close off for a bit.
Yeah.
Everyone that has it dies out and then you resume. Now what's hard is that you can be a carrier for days.
Yeah.
Not having any symptoms. Realize.
That's what makes me nervous. Yeah. That, I think that's why everyone is so like on edge. It's because, fuck, you don't know who has it.
You don't know.
Yeah.
And like, imagine if the people preparing your food, you're like, I'm just going to order food. And then they have it. Imagine you're going to the grocery store. Nobody at the grocery store has it, but the cashier has it. So everyone leaving paying gets sick.
Fuck.
Yeah. Because that cashier, if it's the way they're describing, could produce a fucking new pandemic right there. Because just fucking 1,000 people in a day. Yeah. She just fucked over.
Yeah.
And then those 1,000 people each see one other person.
But CEOs of grocery stores are laughing right now. Hmm. Like fucking all kinds of stupid money they're making.
Yeah, but there's still, it's funny because even in this situation, there are still products that people do not want to buy. Dasani water, because it's shit.
It's true.
Also, I saw a lot of sardines.
Canned salmon, nobody wanted to buy.
Yeah, bro, canned salmon.
Canned salmon. What else? But everything's almost pretty much restocked.
Yeah, guys.
From what I saw yesterday.
I don't know about other cities. I'm not going to talk about it. In Montreal, guys, there's a lot of stock for a lot of this shit. So don't get nervous. You know what I did? It was Friday, right? When everybody panicked. Yeah, because we did a live stream here. You guys remember we did the Quarantine Boys episode 62 of the podcast? Yeah. So what I did is I waited because my girlfriend called me. She's like, I told you just go do some shopping. And she's like, it's fucking packed. They're all crazy. There's no space in the parking lot. And then I said, okay, don't go because if somebody fucking hits you or pushes you, I'm going to have to leave and murder someone.
Yeah.
Go hang out with my mom, and then we'll go right before it closes at 10. There's going to be nobody there because they're all panicking. That's what happened. I went at fucking 9:30, walked around, bought whatever I want. People were restocking shelves.
Yeah.
It was way easier. There was one couple that was walking around. They had full face gears and shit. They were and they were holding hands. You know what they look like? You know what they remind me? Because they were very happy walking around with the face mask all covered. It reminded me of The Purge.
Oh, shit.
Because they were both very happy walking with their face covered. I was like, all right, that's a little sketch.
Okay. Oh, I've seen some people say fucked up shit though on the internet too with everything that happening. What about the boomer remover thing? People are calling it the boomer remover?
Oh, because it's killing old people?
Yeah.
Yeah, but those are idiots.
Fuck, bro. There was this one guy on Twitter that pissed me off. I wanted to rip him, but I withheld.
Yeah, look, dude, I saw tweets about, oh, finally it's going to kill old white men. It's like, bitch, you realize, first of all, China's not white. this has nothing to do with old white men or anything. It's you fucking buffoon.
It's crazy that even during a global crisis, people still choose to be fucking douchebags.
Yeah, but those are what's crazy is when I see those tweets, it's funny because I saw that tweet and I was like, well, this is a person who's an unfunny comic already. It's not a funny comedian. So I was like, it shows in a situation of crisis, you're going to still reach. You're still shit.
Yeah.
You know? That's why you're an open micer. And then it's the same people. You know, it's not going to change anything. People don't change. People are a piece of garbage when they have nothing. They're gonna be a piece of garbage when they have something. Remember that. Yeah.
Oh, definitely.
Housing market hasn't changed. Oh, but housing market takes. Yeah, we can't afford shit. From what I understand, the housing market normally takes about 6 months to react to the rest of the market.
Interesting.
Yeah. So. Yeah.
Oh, what a lot of people have done now too is they've.
I'll give you an example of that right now.
Yeah.
Let's say if right now people can't start paying their mortgage or whatever, they start defaulting. I'm just saying right now, tragic events right now. It's not going to affect all the prices right away because it's going to have the domino effect. It's going to take 6 months for them being like, oh shit, people can't afford houses to buy them and they can't afford to keep them. So the prices have to go down. The only way to make anything is to sell it for cheap, right? But it can't happen if today everyone loses their home. Like, everyone can't start paying. It can't happen overnight. It takes 6 months for everything to start regulating itself.
But let's say nobody can pay the mortgage. Who's going to evict all these people? Let's say it comes to that.
Well, that's what happened in 2008. The bank, they come, yeah. They send people. But that's not... Look, in Italy, they suspended mortgage payments.
Yeah.
So that doesn't happen. Yeah. Obviously, I mean, there are idiots that run a lot of institutions. So it's funny, you could fall on a dumb bank manager that doesn't realize that the smart thing to do would be to extend someone, give them a break for a month or two and let them catch up later after the virus because they can't work or something. Mm-hmm. That would be the smart thing to do because you have to go through so much of a process to take a person's home from them and all. You know what I mean? Like, it's a headache you don't want. But there's always these idiots that are like, rules are rules.
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean? You always find these morons in any...
Yeah.
In any capacity, any job you have, there's going to be those idiots.
I've met a lot of these idiots throughout a lot of my past jobs and it's very infuriating, like...
Well, you know, use common sense. Rules the rules.
Yeah, that pisses me off, bro.
Well, that's kind of what happened to me with Eventbrite today. Because in order...
Yeah.
So the event for Sherbrooke, right? Tickets were through Eventbrite. And, you know, when you pay, you buy your ticket. And part of that ticket is a processing fee. Basically, that's how Eventbrite gets paid, right? So since the event can't take place, I refunded everybody. And Eventbrite gave me the option. If I want to pay everyone their full ticket that they paid or, like, some of it and... so that Eventbrite keeps their cut. So I said, no, pay the whole thing. But in order to pay the whole thing, they charge me. So Eventbrite still wants to make money, so they just made it off me, their processing fee off every ticket. So I was like, guys, it's because of the coronavirus. I didn't fuck around. The people didn't fuck around. It's like, have some common sense and be like, yeah, okay, we're going to waive it. We're not going to make money off the coronavirus.
I'm not defending this. Yeah. I'm not defending Eventbrite, but maybe it's like an automated thing.
Well, I looked. They even have an update on top. They go coronavirus, none of this, and that. So they know what's happening.
Ah, okay. Oh, so they're just scumbags.
Yeah, they're just scumbags. Because even in the option, one of the options wasn't canceling due to this. Like, they didn't want to even give you the option to say, hey, guys, it's this. So there's a lot of this scumbag. Like, you know, but it's always, falls on someone who says, well, rules are rules. It is.
And there's a lot of opportunists when shit like this happens.
John brought it. Brought again, welcome. Brought again, like, am I too late? Did I miss you infecting Poseidon with the Wuhan virus? Poseidon's infected with some other shit that...
Mental retardation.
Yeah, you can't infect him.
Goddamn.
Yeah, Psychohazard said we have a 50% increase in people watching. The quarantine is a blessing for gamers and podcasters. Yeah, man, you guys are going to be home. You're going to be watching all of this shit. And I'm telling you guys right now, this week's episode of Two Drink Minimum... Hilarious. Yes. I think I haven't laughed that much in a very long time. It did us very, very good. Yeah. It did us good. Akash Singh is a hilarious motherfucker. Goddamn. And his shows too. His shows yesterday got canceled.
Everything got canceled.
Yeah, it happened right after Two Drink Minimum was recorded. I got on my phone and somebody sent me a message about, hey, are you sure your shows tonight are going to happen? Because the government just put... the government just put these measures in place where no shows are going to take place. So I sent a text message to David Acker, who owns the Comedy Nest. I was like, yo, I'm with Akash Singh right now. Is he going to do his shows or what's going to happen? He's like, well, why the fuck not? So I sent him the link. He's like, shit, I got to look into this. And that's when we figured out that those shows got canceled too. So the fucking guy came here. He starts doing his show on Thursday. Everything went well.
Yeah.
Then everything starts going kind of weird. People start panicking the next day. Then he's hearing about New York might go on lockdown. He has all this stuff happening. His shows get canceled. It's fucked up for him too, dude. Like, you have to.
Oh yeah.
Like, you're out of country, you know. Your family's New York, let's say, and you. It's fucking weird to be out of country when this shit's going down.
Yeah, 100%.
So the only reason why it was good that shows got canceled, at least he got to go home early and just be there. But it is fucked up. Any plans to also have Schultz this year on your podcast? Well, we were gonna have Schultz last year in the summer during the Just for Last Festival, but we couldn't get organized because he was super busy and. A lot of shit wasn't working out. If he's in town, for sure. This guy's got an open invite. Everyone fucking loves him.
Yeah.
We'll see. We might hook up with him when we're in New York in May. If we make it now, let's see what happens.
Yeah. Man, I love watching his fashion videos.
Fashion. He's a good dude, him.
Yeah.
He's a good dude. All that to say... You're going to need a lot of entertainment now, and I'm telling you, Two Drink Minimum does not fail to deliver this week. Mm. It was a great fucking episode. And we're still going to keep dropping episodes as much as we can do stuff. The only thing I'm not sure about is this just thing, because Phil tends to be a panicky person. So I don't know if he's not going to want to come in, not going to want to shoot. I don't know what his situation is.
Yeah.
So that's the only one that's 50-50. But everything else, you know, we're still going to do it. As long as guests want to come in, I'll do podcasts.
This apparently doesn't affect kids, this virus, either. Right?
Quebec had its first case yesterday of a kid getting sick. Yeah?
Okay.
So I don't... Apparently it won't kill kids unless kids are fucked up.
Yeah.
But...
Because even kids have strong immune systems.
No, they don't have strong immune systems. They don't? Kids. No, they're still developing them. That's why That's why this situation, normally they're scared. Why would kids have strong immune systems? That's the whole point.
Well, because they're always playing in dirt or whatever. So.
That's to develop an immune system.
I see. Okay.
Because if your immune system is naked, it's never it's weak. It doesn't... Immune system, think about it like an army.
Oh, bro, I've rolled training. In dirt. I've eaten ass when I was 8. Bro, I think I'm safe, bro.
Wait, whose ass did you eat when you were 8?
I didn't say that.
Is that where your dad left? He walked in on you and your brothers like, what are you guys doing? We're a human centipede. I'm getting the fuck out of here.
What else?
He starts yelling at your mom. This is your fault. They watched your home movies.
No. No, but in all seriousness, like I played it like I scraped my knees as a kid, everything. So
Most of us did.
Yeah, I think I developed.
Most of us did, dude. No. But it doesn't... This is something new. Our bodies are not used to it. This is a brand new fucking disease.
Yeah.
This is the Wuhan cough. You know, your body doesn't know.
When you
know
cough, you go, Wuhan!
Yeah. I'm thinking about coughing.
That was
coughing
such
now.
A shitty joke. Why did I say that?
Because you're stupid. Because you're stupid and you wanted to suck the fun out of the goddamn room, Poseidon. You're just out here killing us. I take medicine that lowers my immunity. That lowers my immunity. Marco, what medicine lowers you? What do you do? Heroin?
Like, is he too immune? I don't get it.
I'm too strong, bro. I need to even the odds for the rest of the people.
Oh, shit.
Yeah, just be cautious. It usually is because of autoimmunity. Dun, 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 dun. Incels pills. Yeah, you got to be careful, guys, with what the fuck's happening. But like I said, just call the people that are mostly at risk. Take care of them.
Also, vitamin C helps. If you take if you use a lot of lemon.
Helps the coronavirus?
No, helps.
Lemon, lime, corona?
No, helps the kill, I think. Or helps boost the immune system, something like that.
Yeah, it helps boosting, but it doesn't help kill the coronavirus.
No, I know, but it'll help.
Don't say stupid shit. Alex Jones said something like that last week, and people got mad at him. Yeah, he said that he sells a toothpaste on there with silver. He goes, this has been proven it kills the coronavirus.
No, that's not what I was trying to say, but it helps fight it. It helps your immune system fight it.
Vitamin C. I don't think it'll help this.
No?
Have you heard that that's what it helps?
That's what I read.
No, you didn't read it. What helps is you treat it like you can't fight. It's like a flu. You just have to, once you get it, you just have to go through it.
You have to soldier through it.
You can't, you think by you eating oranges, you're not going to get sick from. You can't think like a
villager.
No,
I don't think
like a peasant.
No, I didn't think that. I'm just saying it can help. Like, if you do get it, it won't be as
severe. If you're healthy, obviously, it's going to be easier for you when you're at home recovering from it, just like anything else. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
But what you're saying is stupid, because I know you went and bought a lot of oranges. It does not...
And mandarins.
Yeah, it does not... Unless the mandarins you bought were actual Chinese people, it's not going to help you. I've heard of babies getting it from community spread.
Fuck.
No, I haven't heard anything like that. Hopefully smokers will quit now. Yeah, man, if your lungs are weak. And the problem with Poseidon is he's like, I'm drinking a lot of orange juice, but he's fucking smokes. So he's already the most at-risk person. You are the most at-risk. What do you mean?
One of the most at-risk people.
No, you're the demographic that's most at-risk. You're overweight and you're a smoker.
Yeah, but when I did my blood test, when I did my blood tests, everything was healthy.
No,
except
not
for
everything.
My lungs.
Yeah, you're the most at risk. Why? Because you're a smoker. Yeah, but when I did my blood tests, my lungs were fucked up, so I'm fine. What are you talking about?
No. No. Yeah, I know what you mean.
What puts you at risk? You have it: the lungs and the overweight.
I'm fucked.
Yeah, but hopefully you don't get it.
Yeah.
And if you do...
Hopefully, I'll be part of the 10 to 30% of people that don't get it.
But you know what? Even if you do get it, especially the way we are here, as long as they know, worst case scenario, you'll be on a respirator. They'll just help you breathe.
Yeah. Do you remember the swine flu?
Do I remember it like it was yesterday. It was one of my good friends, yeah.
I remember both my brothers and my mother had caught that.
The swine flu?
Yeah.
Shut the fuck up.
I swear to God.
I didn't know anybody who caught the swine flu.
Are you serious?
Yeah,
both of them caught it. I was the only one that didn't catch it in the house.
They caught the pig flu.
Yeah.
How?
I don't know.
Are you sure it was the pig flu? Because you guys always...
It was a swine flu. Yeah.
Really?
Yeah. When it was going around, when was this? 2014?
Look, bro, I could sit here. When was this? I could make a lot of hog-related jokes right now.
No, but a lot
and
of people...
I want to.
No, look, a lot of people were catching it. Even my youngest brother got it the worst. He was really affected by it. And I remember they all had it. Me, I was unaffected, untouched.
I never met anyone with a swine flu. That's fucking interesting.
Yeah, both my brothers and my mother had it. Me?
Since I never got any of these famous diseases, this is probably my time now. I'm getting the coronavirus.
Fuck.
Catch something, bro. Yeah, I never caught any of
those. Me too. I never caught any of those things. H1N1, any of those, I never caught them.
No. You caught a case of the dum-dums. That's it. Wasn't that bad? I mean, it sucked, but we got a ball of liquid. Yeah, like... In general, most of these, at least, you get flu-like symptoms. You get the flu, basically. So that's the... As long as you're not in the at-risk category, it's fine. Marie Renee is laughing, says, y'all are ludicrous.
We are a little ludicrous.
Yeah. We're a little small black
Move,
rappers.
Bitch. Get out the way.
Yeah, I'm due. I survived everything else. Yeah. It's going to fucking hit me hard. I just hope it doesn't damage my lungs permanently if I get it.
Yeah, because it could cause permanent damage to lungs. I was reading that also. Fuck, man.
Yeah.
I feel like we should change the subject a bit into something else. Because
it's making your lungs hurt, eh?
No, yeah. It's making me paranoid. It's making
my lungs hurt. Again, the reason because he's not getting sick is because Poseidon is basically patient zero. We all know it. Imagine everything just starts from you.
Even in Wuhan.
Because they're asking your parents. You have the swine flu. Have you been around any swine recently? They're like, no, not at all. And then this guy's like, at home. Swimming in his own shit.
And every time, like even this, it originated in China, but somehow they trace it back to me because I ordered something from China. Yeah. But then I didn't like it. I returned it.
Yeah, you poisoned all the Chinese.
It's just me that's been causing pandemics around the world.
Honestly. It's scaring me just thinking about getting... Because you know how your lungs get scarred, apparently, which is fucked up? It's when it's reproducing, like it's making more of the virus. And then when your antibodies are attacking it, it causes permanent scarring.
Yeah. And the fucked up thing about lungs, it's not like...
Lungs are not like hearts. They're lungs.
No. But the thing is also lungs are very complex. They have a lot of...
Valves.
Yeah, I was reading. I didn't read. I watched something about lungs.
Yeah.
A while ago.
They're very complex. They have.
They're very complex to heal and to operate on because of.
They're hot and they're cold. They're yes and they're no.
Because of the way that they are, like it's a lot easier to operate on other organs.
Yeah, of course.
As opposed to lungs.
Plus, you don't want to stop someone's heart by accident.
Yeah.
Me, I'm very worried about getting it just because the lungs.
Yeah. Yeah. Fuck, this is making me nervous.
Yeah, be nervous. I mean, it's normal. You're a human being. You're a sentient being, right? You sense stuff around you. You see that shit's going downhill. Whether you want to or not, you're going to be a little nervous. Everyone is.
Yeah. Somebody told me if you see phone lines starting to cut, no internet, does that get the fuck out of the city?
First of all, who would tell you that? That is the dumbest. That sounds like your father. That is such a... Was it your father? Because that is... It was, eh? That is so fucking stupid. I'm going to tell you something right now. We're not at war. Why would they cut the phone lines?
No, because it's basically an excuse for them to call in martial law. It's super easy when everyone's in their homes and everything.
Okay, again, you're not understanding. Why would they call martial law? We're not fighting against the government. We're fighting a disease. Think about what you're saying.
I know.
Put two and two together.
I know.
If we had everyday riots against the government, then you could be like, if the government decides to cut the water or the electricity, then run. Okay, because you're fighting them. The government's not the problem right now. That's so fucking crazy. And even if they cut phone lines, right? People have cell phones now, bro. And
no, like cell lines. Like no more internet, no more nothing.
Cell lines? What's a cell line?
Well, like the towers, bro.
If they take down the towers?
No, like they stop service completely.
But why would they do that?
I don't know.
For this?
I don't know. I'm not the one that said it.
It makes their... I know, but you perpetuated it. You said a guy told me, a fucking genius... Told me that
a great inventor. Basically,
your dad really told you that.
Modern day Nikola Tesla.
That's a fucking idiot, bro. We're not fighting. It's the dumbest fucking thing right now. We're not fighting the government. It's not the government's. Now the government is not handling it the best, but it's definitely not It's gonna happen.
Yeah.
And we're not in a snowstorm. It's not a blizzard. If the fucking four lines go down, it's not a fucking blizzard, bro. You fucking idiot.
The way you did that voice. Do it again. Do
fucking
it again.
Idiot.
If the phone lines go down.
That's the kind of stupid shit he says. Look at you. I can't believe in your head that stayed. And you're like, fuck, I got to remember that. You know, the government's going to take down the phone lines. How they're going to start with the phone lines and then the internet.
No, I didn't think they're going to do that. I'm just saying.
Yes, you did. You even told us. Here, you said, guys, remember, I heard from someone. Once you do it, you got to get out of the city. Like the government's
no,
trying to
I said,
you.
I said I was told that that's what you have to do if this happens.
But what? Think about what that means for a second.
Yeah, I know.
But just think about what that means. I was told that's what you have to do. Where are you going to go out of the city?
North.
Yeah, what does that mean?
I have no clue.
So don't stay in your home where you have shelter. Just go up into the woods with some wild animals. No preparation, no gear, no know-how, and see how the fuck that works. Great idea, bro. Great fucking thinking. I like it. I like it. And then also go up there with a couple thousand other idiots such as yourself and see who survives the longest.
Well, it wasn't me that was that.
Who gets raped the least, yeah. Good job, buddy.
It wasn't me that was going to do this.
Just leave. Leave as far as you can any supply chain.
Oh, God.
It's so stupid.
I wasn't going to do this. It wasn't me that said this.
Yeah, but then you shouldn't perpetuate it. Because I said a lot of things. I don't repeat things because I didn't say them.
Yeah, you're right. No, you're right. I shouldn't have perpetuated it. I'm sorry. I'm sorry that I perpetuated it.
Like, this wouldn't run in any context. You can't be like, we got to get rid of the Jews. And be like, why would you say that? I didn't say it. Hitler said it. He can't say that. Yeah, but why were you telling people that? I was telling them because he said it. I figure you guys want to know, but I don't sound like I want to say it. It's just that I thought it was a message he was sending people. What are you talking about?
Okay, I'm sorry I perpetuated it. I'm sorry I said that.
You get what I mean,
yeah,
no?
I get it. I get it now. I get it. Oh, you kill me. I love your examples. I love your, analogies?
Yeah, it does sound like Trump. Yeah, that's exactly what it is. A wise man once said, don't let those barbarians in. That man was my uncle. The barbarians was the help. Like, come on.
Oh, shit.
Poseidon would buy all the hot dogs he can, yeah? He's buying the wrong stuff. Yeah, buy. If you are going to go out and get some shit, get some meats, all that, but get a couple of extra stuff that's canned. Just in case you need an extra day or two.
No.
But I don't think we're going to run out of food anytime soon.
No.
Pharmaceutical supplies will be all right. Like I said, it's not like a physical thing, like a tornado. So like, oh, shit, what do we... You know, like,
yeah.
We can always still have the proper people go getting the proper supplies, whether it's between us and the States or boats or whatever. So don't overreact.
Don't panic.
Don't panic. Because I saw a guy, where was it, in Georgia yesterday, got stabbed for a case of water in like a Target.
What?
Yeah.
God damn.
Somebody broke a wine bottle and stabbed him.
Oh, what the fuck, bro?
Yeah. Yeah. So calm the fuck down.
People are tripping balls, bro.
Yeah.
There was a lady that almost got trampled at a Costco entrance because everyone stormed the doors as soon as it opened.
Why are you storming the doors like it's fucking Black Friday, you buffoons?
Oh, and they released CCTV footage of people, people going to the toilet paper aisle and just fucking going nuts.
Yeah.
Fuck, bro.
Mom, do we have any food left? No, go take a shit and wipe your ass. We have the best fucking toilet paper situation in the whole neighborhood. Count your blessings, girl. But I'm hungry. It doesn't matter. You can wipe your ass comfortably. Fucking idiots. Like, worst case scenario. Wouldn't you just go if you have no toilet paper, but you're stuck in the house, but you have food? Wouldn't you rather have food and no toilet paper?
I definitely have
food. And then
food.
Just wash your ass in the fucking shower 100%, or some shit?
100%.
Right? That's the worst case scenario.
Yeah.
You bidet it.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
It's fucking crazy.
Yeah.
Out of very random curiosity, have either of you able to do an Irish accent? You seem like you can change your voice well, so I'm curious. I can't do any accent. All my accents are the same. They're all crazy, and they don't make any sense. This guy here, can you do an Irish accent?
I could do a British accent.
That's not British.
What are you talking
about? That's you pretending to be British.
What do you mean? I'm speaking in British.
I'm speaking in British. Why, do they all have speech impediments? I'm speaking in British. when Rob comes over, is that how he sounds? Have as well. Is that how he talks, you fucking psycho? What the fuck was that? The fuck? We have the coronavirus. What's wrong with you? Jesus. Do that again.
I can't now.
Oh, come on.
I can't.
So do you think British people just don't complete their words? We're waiting.
I can't now. I can't.
You're right there, bud.
Yes, I'm fine.
Yes. I'm not good with... If I hear someone talking, I could copy. But off the top of my head, I don't know if I was never good at accents, but the voices I make, people laugh at, but I never intend to do an accent. It just comes out. Like, I see someone, and I just assume what they should sound like in a cartoon, and then that's what I do.
Oh, God, that was funny.
Was it?
It was quite funny.
Funny.
Nigel, I'm fucking tripping balls over here, mate.
You see, you lose it every three words.
Yeah. Oh, well. I used to be a bit better, I find. I'm very good at animal noises.
Of course, you have to communicate with your family.
I could do it.
I too speak my mother tongue. I'm very good at the moo.
I could do a pig being slaughtered.
What is wrong with you?
I could do a horse.
Oh, can you?
Yeah.
Let's hear it.
Hold on, because I can't do these things while looking at you all like...
First of all, you're sitting here squealing like a goddamn pig. All right. I just want to remind people. This is a goddamn pandemic.
There's a new entertainment.
People are losing their fucking minds. This guy's here squealing like a fucking pig.
This is the new entertainment.
What is the real sickness here? I think you have the ailment.
This is the new era.
I want to hear your horse first, and then we'll go. I'm ashamed that I know you.
I can do sheep.
I hope you get cancer. I could do a sheep. Is that what you said?
Yes, I could do a sheep. I gotta stop. I can't. I'm laughing too much.
There's a small chance that I murder you and then claim Corona got you.
with a knife through my heart. Corona, bro.
You're fucking... And then people are like, why doesn't Poseidon take advantage of the fame and do stand-up? This is why. This is why you're going to go to a comedy club and be like, and now, you know, for two trick minimum, it's Poseidon.
And then all you're going to hear is...
And he comes with like, guys, let me know if you know who this is. That's right. That's my mom.
I'm going to come up on stage and all you're going to hear is... Bah.
Somebody gets up and beats the shit out of you with a mic stand. Yeah, he laughs like a donkey too. Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Imagine Poseidon as Anthony Hopkins in Silence of the Lambs. He does know what Silence of the Lambs. Have you ever watched Silence of the Lambs?
Wasn't that the Hannibal Lecter guy?
Yeah. You ever watch it?
No. Ah, I might watch it now, actually, with the...
Yeah, I might watch it now.
With what's going on.
It's fucking open season for the cinemas. Honestly, you would make a great live-action Shrek. That's what Pat DeRose is saying.
Yeah? You just paint me green?
With that accent, too. Come here, donkey.
Come here, donkey.
Yeah. Yeah, you'd be good.
What does he say about his swamp? Leave my swamp. What does he say?
I don't fucking know what he says.
What's that catchphrase? Can somebody say it in the chat?
What the fuck do you care what his catchphrase is? So you're actively pursuing the role of the live-action Shrek. Instead of fighting it off, you're like, I know my strengths.
Look.
I'm not quoting Smash Mouth, they go. But that's it. That's Poseidon's. Honestly, when Poseidon's life story comes out and they make a movie of it, that's how it's going to start. It's going to have him walking out of a swamp. Hey now, you're a rock star. That's it.
Listen here now, Pantelis. Oh, God. You made me laugh.
Oh, did I?
Yeah.
Then that's it. I did my job.
Yeah.
I'm making the world a better place.
Yeah.
Didn't they do a theatrical production of Shrek? I don't fucking know.
Did they? I don't know.
Poseidon, I'm wondering.
Man, there's a picture that makes me laugh. But it's a picture, so I'm not going to get into it. I'm not going to do the same mistake. It's Shrek-related.
So why'd you bring it up?
I don't fucking know. I do the same mistake. Anyways, what were you going to say?
I don't know. I was going to ask if there's any updates.
Of?
Of the coronavirus here. In case people showed up late, just to let them know, in Montreal.
Well, there's like 35 now.
Bars, theaters, gyms, pools, ski hills are all closed. Yeah. Until further notice. Restaurants are ordered to operate at 50% capacity to give people distance between each other. And that means that service industry jobs are fucked. Unless you work at a restaurant, you'll get 50% of the tips.
Wait, does this mean since hold on, question now. Since,
I'm listening.
Since the restaurants are forced to operate at 50% capacity,
yeah.
Does that mean that now people have to give double the tip? So they have to give 30% tip to make up for the other 50% that can't make it?
What?
Since they're forced to operate at 50% capacity, do you think they're going to start demanding double the tip?
No. Because can't demand double the tip. No. The only thing that's going to happen is that 50% of the staff is fucked.
Yeah, basically.
Yeah, that's all that's going to happen. Let's see. They had to have played Smash Mouth. What? No, I don't want to play Smash Mouth. Like, look, if I'm going to get in trouble for fucking playing music, Bob Marley, I'm cool with it, but I don't want to get in trouble playing Smash Mouth. But like, we're sorry, Pantelis, you big Smash Mouth fan. I don't want anybody to think I'm a Smash Mouth fan.
What the fuck is Smash Mouth?
The band.
There's a band called Smash Mouth?
I'm going to smash your fucking mouth, bro. Like, I don't know. Are you serious?
You know what's funny? You roll your eyes so intensely that even when you close your eyes, you can see your eyes rolling behind your eyelids.
Yeah.
That's very interesting. Yeah. I just noticed. I've never noticed before. I just noticed.
If I don't like you, Poseidon, you know it. No one is ever like, I don't know if Pendels likes me or not. No, you know. You know.
You wear your emotions on your face.
Yes.
Or on your sleeve.
Yeah, where else would I wear my emotions, by the way, for the record? You normally, how do you show your emotions? Through your asshole? You?
On my stomach.
Just lifts his shirt up.
And my two nipples and my belly button. Mouth.
Did Mike's live
eyes.
Podcast get canceled?
I think we went over this.
Yeah, I think we went over this, Pat. I don't know which live podcast you're talking about. Anything this month, this entire month, live events that have people have been canceled. Been canceled.
The whole month of March has been canceled.
March doesn't exist.
Yeah.
We're here in limbo, all right?
No.
I'm doing this podcast because this guy is not scared of disease.
I'm immune.
He has most of them.
I got tiger blood. I got tiger blood.
Marie Renee, again, that's July 18th. That's not March. So we don't know yet for July 18th. Right now, yeah. Everything's a go, but I don't know what the future has in store. Either we're all going to be dead by July. There's going to be a fucking worldwide crisis. We can't cancel the whole year in advance, and then everybody just fucks off. As of right now, July is a go. Now, if there's a law in July again that says you can't have more than fucking 50 people somewhere, then obviously we can't do the arena show.
Question. Let's say all the drug dealers get sick. What happens when the crackheads stop getting all their crack?
They heal.
Aren't they going to get a little fiendy and...
Crackheads are already fiendy, bro. That's what you're nervous about right now?
No.
Everyone's nervous about their grandparents.
It's just a question that arose.
Their coworkers, their friends. This guy's like, but what about the crackheads?
No, but I'm saying maybe they might get violent.
What do you care if they get violent? They're crackheads. When are crackheads not violent?
You make a good point.
What the fuck do I care about?
So it was just a question that arose. I'm making a conversation. I'm bringing up different topics.
So look, until mid-April, nothing's going down. That's for sure. Then after that, we're going to see. We're going to take it one step at a time.
People were making a lot of joke that there's going to be a lot of corona boomers born.
Yeah, there's going to be a lot of babies in nine months.
Yeah, a lot of babies in 9 months.
Yeah. Don't do that, by the way.
Yeah.
Try your best to put some condoms on. Yeah.
There's going to be a lot of Scorpios being born.
Because they're like, yo, we're not working right now, so we're just going to fucking make babies. Yeah, but if you're not working, how are you going to pay for those babies when they come out, stupid?
Child labor.
All right, Poseidon.
Did you like how I...
Well, Poseidon is going to be working, at least we know that. I mean, next Saturday, Poseidon's live stream is going up again.
Yeah.
So on the Patreon, Poseidon's going to be doing In Bed with Poseidon next week. It's going to be his first episode with brand new equipment.
Yeah.
Green screen and all that shit.
Yeah, yeah.
Lights.
Which, so, you're going to teach me how to use the green screen? The lights I can figure out.
I don't think you can figure anything. I'll help you just set everything up just to be safe. Yeah. Yeah, next week you'll do that. Saturday.
Yeah.
Give everybody an opportunity. I'm going to see if for the... I'm going to talk to some French guests. Now, for the French cast and the Pantelis podcast, I mean, I'm willing to do it, but we're going to have to see what happens with guests. Maybe there's going to be people who are scared, comedians that are scared to come on. They don't want to leave their houses. I don't
with
know.
With reason.
Yeah, it depends on the comic, right?
Yeah.
So, you guys see the Italy video of people thanking China? Yeah, I saw something on Twitter, but I'm hoping it was sarcastic. Like, thanks, China.
Yeah.
But I love because they're like, China sent some help. Yeah. Yeah, they should have. They fucking put you in this mess.
Yeah.
Like, you know what it's like? It's like you get beaten and raped by someone. It's like, but at least he drove me to the hospital. So nice. Are you fucking crazy? Did you forget how you got in this situation in the first place?
Yeah.
God damn it.
People are saying, I saw this one video that made me fucking die of laughter. It's this woman really playing the flute very poorly on her balcony. This during, because you know all the Italians are all singing on their balconies.
Very happy, the Italians.
Very happy people. And her husband gets mad at her because he's annoyed. And then he smacks the flute out of her mouth with the water bottle.
No, really?
And she starts screaming at him. That's smacking fine. Him, bro. I was dying of laughter. He's like, shut the fuck up.
Let's see. I've seen a couple of economists on YouTube expecting the economical crisis to reach the level of the Great Depression. I saw that,
fuck.
Too. Yeah. I've seen a good couple podcasts about this on the Peak Prosperity channel. No, no, I've heard about this, guys. I've heard that we're going to eat a huge dick. So be fucking careful. And especially the people, like I said, who are losing their jobs now that are in the service industry or any company. There might be some companies that, I don't know, it depends on what you're in, right? Let's say you're in a company that sends stuff to bars. I don't know, you know, something like that, or those, you know, because it's all connected.
It's
right?
all connected.
So
yeah.
If part of that ecosystem is removed, then you gotta find. So yeah, be.
Do you
be
think
weird.
Some companies are gonna go under during this time of crisis?
For sure, there's always companies that go under during times of crisis.
No.
Gabe says this is worse than 9/11. It's worse in the sense that it's affecting everybody more. Like 9/11 was more emotional. It happened once, bang, and then you could get over it.
No.
This is kind of like, wait, where does this stop? How do I keep moving?
Yeah, this is like a winter. Who was saying this was
like a nuclear winter?
Yeah, it was the Joe Rogan podcast, that expert there. He's like, this isn't the coronavirus blizzard. He goes, it's like a coronavirus winter. This is gonna last.
Yeah, it's gonna last a while.
Yeah.
So, you think it will affect my cannabis farm?
So strap in, folks.
The physical farm, Marco. I don't think it'll affect the physical farm. I think more people are gonna be wanting to get high now. Anyway.
Yeah. Yeah, it makes sense.
Right?
Yeah.
That's what I think. A lot of people are going to be drinking.
Drinking, smoking.
Staying at home doing parties.
No.
A lot of video games. I think now's the time for you to start playing online games with your friends.
Yeah, yeah.
Like, stay home, bro.
There's the new Warzone came out and fucking Call of Duty capitalized. This weekend, because of what's happening, they put double XP. double XP, double weapon XP, everything.
That means if you play, you get double the
shit. Yeah, exactly. So, I guess.
They know what they're doing. They know how to sell.
Yeah. And yeah,
so corner stores are gonna boom. Yeah, anybody that's selling, like, corner stores, grocery stores, all that, they're the ones that are gonna come out of this fine.
No,
right? Imagine a grocery store that gets infected, and the entire staff, the whole company, is fucked and they can't go. How is this affecting people's Patreons? Patreons are gonna feel it too, because there's gonna be people that lose their jobs. So, for example, right now, normally what happens in these situations, when people lose money, their jobs, the first thing to go is entertainment, which makes sense, right? You do you want to eat or do you want to watch a movie? You're going to eat first.
Yeah.
So, patrons are going to be affected by that, but there's a double-edged sword. The people who have money but don't have anywhere to go or anything to do, they're going to jump on Patreon and stuff like that to help, like, support, you know, videos, arts, all that, and they can watch shit to keep that moving.
Mm.
But other people are going to have to cancel because they're like, yo, I got to buy food and I don't have a job anymore.
Mm.
So it's a double-edged sword for Patreon. For entertainment, it's always a double-edged sword. Mm. Like, already we lost all kinds of money. Like, this month, all live performances. Like, fuck, a lot. Like, I lost a lot of gigs this month. So Mike had to fucking, you know, theater shows. fucking that were postponed. Yeah. That's a shit ton of money, man. That's it's a lot. Already some stores and bars that had to close. A week of closing cost them $360,000.
God damn, bro.
So a month, you're fucked. You gotta start letting people go. Yeah, because everything still needs to get paid.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I know. But so all this to say, strap your boots in real tight.
Yeah, strap your boots in. Be smart with your money.
Yeah.
And look around you, man. Like I'm saying, there's a lot of people that are gonna need you right now. So take care of them. Always way more important. Take care of the people that fucking need it, and everything else will work itself out. Don't worry about me. Don't worry about Poseidon. We're gonna be good. I'm taking care of the kid. I'm gonna feed him after this. Might be time to start a cult, Pantelis. A forehead tattoo. I got my emergency sweater on today because it draws attention. It's red. Listen, people, there's a goddamn emergency.
Wait, shouldn't you not wear red then? You don't want to draw attention to
it? No, I got to draw attention. I'm letting them know this is an emergency broadcast.
Yes, I see.
So it's red for emergencies. Oh, by the way, another thing that pissed me off. So when we canceled, well, we postponed actually till April 4th, but that might have to get extended too now, the Southern Boys show, right? So a couple of things really fucking bothered me about that thing. I forgot to talk about it. I was thinking about it on the way here, and I was like, you know what? That's actually fucked up. So we were talking about it. It was the day, what was it? Friday, I think it was day of, right? Friday or Thursday when it happened?
Friday.
And the news was coming in, and then they put in, even though he's like, you know, 250 people gatherings, you know.
It was Thursday, max, actually, sorry.
It was Thursday.
Yeah.
So we were still talking about it for a while, me, Guido, and Massimo, just to be like, you know, we don't want to fuck people over. So do we do the show? Do we not do the show? We had a long discussion,
yeah,
soul searching kind of, to decide what's best to do. And then we said that the best decision can't be what's good for us. The best decision is people, safety, all that shit. We can't fuck around. So we let them know. And then they were apparently giving Guido, who called to give him the message of we got to postpone, said they were giving him shit. At first, one of the guys was like, are you sure this and that? And then Guido was like, hey, dickhead, turn on the TV. It's mandated by law, right?
What?
Yeah. And then the lady who had to change the date, just change the date, was like, oh, are you sure you want to do this? Because you know it's going to be a lot of work for me.
What?
What? Like, when I heard that, I was like, are you fucking kidding me? Like, it got me inside. I was so angry. I was like, what? That's what you fucking think? It's going to be a lot of work for me.
Fuck.
First of all, there's a fucking, the government already spoke out. So fucking have, when the government tells you don't do it, have a show and get someone sick and see what the fuck happens. See it's how liable you are. Me. Yeah, it's going to be a lot of work for me to change the date on the fucking website. If that's a lot of work for you, then maybe you're in the wrong
industry.
You know
industry. What? I hope she gets the virus, whoever that fucking lady is.
But it's just so that kind of stuff. You know, people are like, oh, you get mad too easily. But this kind of shit pisses me the fuck off. You know what I mean? I get mad at shit like that. It's like,
but
fuck.
That's you know what? Like, I thought I was selfish. Like, sometimes I could be inadvertently selfish without realizing. Like, simple shit. Like, if I have a guest over, I'll forget to ask them if they want to drink something, water. Like, basic shit, right?
Basic human decency.
You know? But like, this is like next level. This is active selfishness. This is next level scumbaggery, I find, in my opinion.
Apparently Guido lost his shit. Guido's like, what do you mean
good.
It's work for you? Bitch, there's a law. Like, what do you want me to do? The fucking government spoke out. Like, what?
Yeah.
What if people get sick? Like, what do you want to do?
But this is, fuck.
And then Guido spent like 4 hours because all the people that he sold physical tickets to that he wasn't sure because they don't use the internet, he called them, bro, one by one to let them know.
Good for Guido.
Yeah, that's badass.
I'm happy for him. I'm happy
just
so that
they don't show up.
Yeah.
Just that they don't show up. So shit like that. So when I hear stuff like that, I'm like, I don't fucking like that stuff. You know, like, you gotta.
No, everyone I sold tickets to has access to the internet.
No, but I post everywhere. It was on Instagram. I did a story. I did a post. I put it on Facebook, Twitter. I let everyone know. Even for Sherbrooke, I'm letting everyone know. But Sherbrooke, at least, whoever bought tickets got refunded because they all bought online.
Yeah.
So whether they know now or not, they're going to get an email. You got your money back. So they're going to figure out that something's done. So that's the good thing, at least.
Yeah.
Even though Eventbrite likes to fuck around.
But fuck that lady, man.
Yeah, isn't that annoying?
That's fucking it's aggravating, actually.
I'm not being too...
More than annoying.
I'm not being too easily pissed off. That is a piss-off, right?
No. That's very aggravating.
Yeah, look
it's
at
a
the
lot
fuck.
Of... There's a humanity... There's a global crisis happening. It doesn't want to press a few fucking buttons on the computer.
You want me to update that website now? Like, Jesus fucking Christ, man. God damn.
It's very aggravating.
Yeah. And then it's funny because he goes... He was telling me, he's like, what if they ask us, like, what if they demand us to pay to change the date or something like that? I go, see if they say something like that. If they say something like that, I'm going to go there and break someone's legs. We're going to see who the real fucking mob is.
I'm coming
say,
with
yeah,
you.
Yeah, say something like that. Say, I'm coming say with you. During a crisis when the government said you can't do anything this day, we'll charge you change. Say something like that. Have the ball say it. But nobody's saying anything like
no,
that.
No, no, no.
I would have lost my fucking shit.
I would have lost my shit for you, bro.
Yeah.
With you.
Because that's really taking advantage
yeah,
of
yeah, yeah, yeah. That's
Yeah.
Yeah, that's opportunistic. Oh, no.
They didn't go that far, at least.
No, at least.
That would have been fucking crazy. But as far as shows are concerned, a lot of people, man, you're going to have to get your entertainment from us online. But the good thing is we have a lot of shit. Like, even on this webpage, there's a lot of videos. Yeah. If you go back, if you haven't seen everything.
Just on Pantel's Comedy, there's a ton of
on Pantel's Comedy, content. Mike's got a lot of shit on his on the Mike Ward page and that. On the Suzekut yeah. channel. So there is a lot of shit, and we're going to keep producing stuff.
Oh, and also, this is a perfect time for people to even subscribe to 2DM Clips.
Oh, yeah, little clips.
Yeah, little clips, because there's also a lot of stuff.
But now
on
people
that.
Have free time, so they're going to be watching full videos. Yeah. A lot of people are going to get into podcasts now for the first time.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, it's true. There's going to be new podcasters.
Yeah, there's going to be new podcast fans. Yeah.
And
new podcasters. Someone out there for sure is going to do their quarantine cast.
Yeah.
I've been in quarantine for 3 days now.
Well, fucking, what's his name? Massimo already put out 3 videos.
No, but those are the joke videos. But I'm saying someone who has coronavirus and has to be quarantined, self-quarantined, should do a video blog. Every day, coming online and talking what he's doing, how's his day, how's he feeling. It would be pretty cool.
I would do that if I didn't have to go to work tomorrow. I think I would start that.
That's if you have coronavirus. If you have coronavirus, you can't go to work tomorrow.
I see what you mean.
I don't think you do.
I got it. I said something stupid. Never mind.
Oh, yeah. You did say something stupid. Yeah. No, you just basically, if you have the coronavirus, you update people every day how you're feeling. You know, and then
yes, because it'll really also
It'll make other people feel less scared about getting it.
Yeah, it'll shine a lot of light on how. Yeah. That would be a.
Ray Miller is shocked at your stupidity, by the way. He's like, oh my God, Poseidon is an idiot. Yeah, I know. It's
Ray, I too am shocked at my stupidity.
Yeah. Yeah, it'll be interesting just to see how the symptoms differ from the regular flu. And then you see the person recovering. I think it'll, because like I said, about 70% of us are probably going to get it by the end of the year. So it'll help a lot of people just be calm. Cruise ships recirculate air equals fail. I don't know, Gapes. I didn't talk about a cruise ship, but I'm.
Yeah, because it was a whole thing that happened with the cruise ships. People were stuck on cruise ships.
Yeah, you shouldn't be on cruise ships, but I don't know where that comes from. I didn't say anything about cruise ships. Sorry, it just hit me, Raymond said. Well, so does aircraft. Yeah, the air, same thing in the sky, man, in a plane. It's the same fucking air. Like, just when you're traveling now, you're in danger because people coughing in the plane. It's just the air is going around in there.
Imagine this is like some kind of like crazy conspiracy, like, and this coronavirus is just a sleeper agent, and that's why 70 to 90% of the people are gonna catch it, and then in about 5 years from now, it's gonna activate, and everyone's gonna turn into zombies. And then the people who didn't catch it, the 10 to 30% people of the planet that didn't catch it, have to fend off the zombies.
Go home.
It's a joke. I make a joke.
You make a stupid.
Oh, shit.
Yeah, it's not. It's definitely not. That.
I know. Obviously, I'm just fucking busting balls.
Yeah, people are like, but why?
Because you gotta fucking alleviate some of the stress, bro.
It was a joke set up, Pantelis. Poseidon condoms recirculate cum. Yeah. Snakes on planes are a lot less scary now. Yeah. I guess.
No, I think snakes on a plane are still pretty fucking scary, bro.
Not as scary as this, because a snake, you could see it.
Yeah, but still, bro.
It's a snake. It can't jump. Put your feet up. Enjoy the ride.
Really? It's that simple? I don't think it's that simple, bro.
It's that simple.
When you have a gigantic fucking python.
I think that's the problem with that movie. Snakes on a Plane. Samuel L. Jackson didn't tell people, you just put your legs up and just chill. Put your legs up, guys. And that's it. We make it. And then once we get down, they'll come on. They'll escort the snakes off. We get off. We're all fine. Instead, everybody panics, start jumping on the floor. Who jumps on the goddamn floor when there's snakes on the goddamn plane? Stay chill, bitch. Stay chill.
I'll just start stomping. stomping on snakes.
But there's so many motherfucking snakes on this motherfucking plane.
Stomp on all them motherfuckers.
You can't stomp on them all. While you're stomping, another one's coming from the back and slides up, goes inside. The second it goes inside your asshole and it goes inside you, you're fucked. Yeah. Just put your legs up. Put your legs up and chill. Put your headphones on. Listen to some non-snake related music. That's it. I just solved snakes on a plane.
The first song that comes onto your shuffle playlist is "My Anaconda Don't." My Anaconda, you're like, fuck.
Yeah, just put your fucking legs up. That would have been the best way to end that movie. The snakes on this motherfucking plane. It's like, all right, put your legs up. All right. The end.
Shortest movie ever.
It's like, goddamn, that was a short film.
It would have been funny if it would have been funny if like at the end of the movie the song came on. My Anaconda Don't.
So Jofo says, how long until it starts becoming trendy and cool to post about catching coronavirus? Yeah, it might. I don't know if it's gonna be trendy or cool, but more and more people are supposed to get it, so you're gonna see it more and more.
Oh, do you think there's gonna be those hipsters that are gonna be like,
try to catch it?
That are gonna try to catch
it, like bug catchers,
just to be cool.
Yeah, there's those gay guys that go in like the gay communities and they try to catch like STDs, AIDS, and all that. They're called bug catchers. Yeah, there might be some of those for coronavirus for sure.
Fuck,
bro. I had coronavirus before. It was cool. Yeah, hipsters. Yeah, it's a hipster thing for coronavirus because it doesn't kill you, but they just want to be first.
Yeah.
Now I'm immune. I'm going to China, guys.
I hope it kills them.
I'm going to report live from China because I can't catch it anymore. But you know what you can still catch in China when you go there with a camera? A beating.
Yes.
So they're not immune
to it. Or worse. Death.
Yeah.
Get waterboarded.
Oh, yeah. If they fucking catch you there with the government trying to report on the Wuhan virus, you're fucked.
Bro, they got rid of a fucking...
A tycoon. They got rid of a billionaire, bro.
Bro, a billionaire, bro. This guy has resources, bro.
Yeah. Talk shit, get nicked. That's it. He's done.
But then again, these hipsters are a slippery bunch.
Yeah, I don't know if they're slippery. They're greasy, but yeah, go on.
Like they can, you know, they can slip.
Nah, I don't think you get go unnoticed as a North American hipster in China.
Obviously.
You're taller than everyone.
Nah, you got a beard.
You have a fucking man bun.
You look like a faggot.
Yeah, they could tell from all of them. Poseidon went all in on that one. Like, I hate these fucking hipsters. You're there with a mason jar. you're drinking lemonade with the mason jar.
The only way that they could blend in is if they start riding their bicycle everywhere like they do here.
They can't blend in, bro. Everyone in China looks Chinese and you don't.
I know.
Sick burn, Poseidon, they're saying. What are they updating? Dude, here's another thing. I keep getting messages from everyone, Bell Canada, everything. Stay up to date on the coronavirus. Let me tell... Dude, what are you going to do for me during the coronavirus? Shut the fuck up. Bro, stop acting concerned.
Yeah. That pissed me off. I got emails from fucking TD and Scotiabank saying...
We got you covered,
Scotiabank. We just want you to know that we're here in this great time of need.
You
want to
give me money? Yeah. No. Fuck off.
You want to be here in this time of need? How about you deposit $500,000 in my bank account?
Give me some money, bro.
How about you fucking send some of that fucking, you know?
What do you mean by we're here for you? Yeah. The website is open.
Yeah. Yeah. How about you wipe my credit card debt? How about that?
Well, it's not Scotia's fault there, but yeah.
No, obviously, but I'm saying like...
No, but I'm just saying like, we're here for you. No, you're not. You're just the same you were yesterday. Yeah. The website's...
But it's this whole bullshit of they're trying to seem like fucking... Like,
Gabe says he got an email from KFC and Enterprise.
What?
Yeah, KFC's like, don't worry, bro. We got your chicken.
I hate it when companies do this, bro. It pisses me off. They do this to seem like super like...
So Jofo's asking you, what are your preventative measures for people that still want to go to prostitutes during this time?
Oh, I posted on my story. It's a whole body condom.
Are you going to buy a body condom?
No, obviously the fuck not. But I'm just not going to go to prostitutes.
He was asking seriously what works.
No, you just don't fucking go, bro.
Is that what's going to happen?
100%.
So you just want all these ladies to go hungry. That's what you're saying?
Bro,
you're willing to risk the lives of the only people that have showed you love and caring through these past couple of years. You're willing to turn your back on them.
Look,
the people that were willing to touch you when no one wanted to even look at you.
I don't know what to say.
You're willing to do this to them.
I don't know what to say to this now.
You disloyal piece of shit.
No, but I mean, fucking. You know what you do?
Yeah.
You grab one of them. Yeah. You're like, look, I got a shit ton of food in my place. We're on lockdown. Or you order one right before lockdown. She comes over. Yeah, we're on lockdown. You can't leave.
I don't think you know what lockdown is, Poseidon. Lockdown doesn't mean they're going to lock in your home here.
No, I know.
It just means that you're not allowed to leave the country.
Oh, shit. I don't know. I honestly don't know. I haven't given a thought because I'm just not going to go.
I want to see how long that lasts. I give you one day in quarantine.
Yeah? Until I read an ad that says $50 to suck your dick?
No, I just... For 2 hours? So just something turns you on. Like you read an article about bat soup and then you lose your shit.
I'm just going to masturbate a lot.
Can someone confirm that the manifestation against police brutality is going on right now in Montreal?
Wait, what?
I hope that it's going on, and I hope that every one of those idiots gets beat up by the police. Like, there's a time and place for everything, right?
Yeah, like France held
the Yellow Vest protest. There's a time and place for everything, guys. Right now, the problem in the city is not that the cops are beating anyone up. The problem in the city is this virus, which you're supposed to avoid, mass gatherings for. So you're going into a mass gathering to protest something that's not happening here, but just you're part of the ideology that hates police brutality everywhere, which everyone can get behind that.
Yeah.
But I don't like police brutality any more than you do. But by going downtown when they're asking people to stay home and fighting with police, you're not helping anything. These fucking idiots, man.
It's like France. France, they broke a world record. A world record. They held a parade, and all the people in the parade dressed up as Smurfs.
Yeah.
And it was a record-breaking number of people in this parade. For no fucking reason while all this is going on.
Yeah, the most retarded people dressed as Smurfs. That was the world record they broke. Is that for real? I don't know if it's happening right now. If somebody could tell me if the protest is happening, but that is the dumbest thing. Like, you gotta... It's so fucking stupid. You know what I mean? Like, look, be self-aware. Be a little self-aware.
But you know what? Also, probably because these people think that police, like, all the public services, they're all gonna be busy. Police, firefighters, and all that.
No, so but what are you... But opportunistic for what? What are you protesting? No one's paying attention to... Like, a protest normally is you want to draw attention to something, right?
Yeah, yeah.
No one is watching this or taking you seriously.
100% true.
No one is. Who would take you seriously?
If anything, they'd get even more angry at you.
Yeah, I'm angry at them. I don't like police brutality, but if you're out there right now fighting with the cops, we don't need this right now. The worst part is these people are young. They won't die if they get it, but they'll spread it as fuck. Yeah, it's just idiots. It's just these fucking idiots, man. We're protesting. Is that the problem right now on the planet? Is police brutality really... It's not bat soup. I think bat soup is the real issue here.
Fuck, man. I saw some videos on that. Like, they even packaged turtles like it was fucking chicken breasts, bro.
Yeah, it's disgusting.
It's crazy, bro.
Yeah. That's another thing. We got to...
They had fucking eels, bro. They had all kinds of crazy, wild shit, bro.
Corona narcissism. There's already mourning narcissism. Yeah, there's a lot of people, I think. I think you guys said it before. Someone said in the chat, and you guys are right. A lot of people are going to use it as an excuse. Be like, I got the corona, bro. So stupid. It's going to be a pickup line. I already got corona. Can't get her twice. I'm down. Yeah. It's going to be a lot of that shit happening.
I'm disgusted.
Yeah. Update your Tinder profiles. Corona free since 93. That should be your line. Let's see here. Morning narcissism, evening narcissism, when you're narcissistic. Yeah, yeah. You don't have to think about that, guys. Now I'm all I'm pissing you guys off just mentioning the protest downtown. I don't know if it's happening. Somebody mentioned in the chat it was supposed to happen, I guess. But a lot of people mention sometimes in the chat stuff that isn't real. Another random question is Pantelis and Poseidon, your actual names your parents gave you. That is my fucking name.
Yeah.
Fuck, is that supposed
That's
to mean
my name?
Yeah.
And I don't like the way you're asking too many questions.
Yeah. My fucking name. It's not a goddamn stage name. I don't know why people think it's a fucking stage name. Pantelis is a Greek name. I don't know why. It's not the first time somebody asked me that.
No.
It's a stage name. If it's a fucking stage name, why wouldn't I pick a regular name?
And even if it was.
No, but then it would just be a stage name. Yeah. But if it was a stage name, I'd pick something else.
What would you pick as a stage name?
I don't know, like fucking Bill Powers. I don't know, like something like easier and short and normal. You get it? So it rolls off the tongue. It's easy to remember.
If I had to pick a stage name, it would be Batman.
No, that wouldn't be your stage name because that's copywritten.
Oh, fuck. It's true. You're right.
Because Batman exists. And why would you...
It would be Batman with two T's.
But you don't look like anything that has to do with Batman unless you eat bats. Like, I don't... Like, if somebody sees you, they don't think Batman.
They think Fat Man.
They think Fat Man, yeah.
I love how I just ripped myself. I had to. It was right there.
Yeah, you said,
it was too easy.
You're getting in there and you're taking a bite out of crime.
Oh, shit. That was funny. So, I preemptively ripped myself on that one.
Oh, shit. We just heard about a rape. Who are we going to call? Fat Man. Oh, yeah, he never picks up. This guy's always eating.
Oh, shit.
All right. So, guys, before we end the stream, I want to remind you guys, just, you know, keep clean. Fucking, these are regular things I don't have to fucking remind you people of. You already know this. It's not your fault. this is the Wuhan virus coming out there. I'm going to try to recover from my cold in the meantime. Poseidon. You could catch him on ThePoseidon69 Instagram and the Twitters, and he'll be tweeting. We're going to come back with new videos this week. I'm hoping to do a podcast this week, both a French and an English one.
Yeah, yeah.
It's going to depend on whether my guests want to come. They might want to leave. They might not want to leave their houses this week, their homes this week, just because of everything that's going down. Remember, if you can, guys, first thing you're going to do is... call fucking relatives, friends that you have that are nearby that may be at risk, you know, older people, some young people. And also remember your friends that are in industries that are shutting down for a month. If they need something, look out for them. The best way to get around this right now isn't to panic, isn't to go buy toilet paper. It's just, you know, if everybody takes care of themselves and then we survive this, and then we'll be okay in a couple of weeks, couple of months. And, you know, we'll talk more. And apart from that, thank you all. You know, for those of you, the patrons, thank you so much. Patreon.com/Pantelis, PantelisComedy.com for all of... I would tell you my dates, but we don't know what the fuck's going to happen with those. Already, shit's getting canceled. So thank you all for listening. Hopefully, this helped you guys out for 2 hours to just stop thinking about this fucking virus. And if there's any fucking updates, I won't hide them. I'll share them.
Well, all we spoke about was the virus.
You all, the virus.
Ciao, ciao.